By pro-Russian separatists. President Obama expected to unleash a new round of sanctions, which he'll talk about today.
The European Union expected to impose broad sanctions on Russia for the first time since the crisis in Ukraine began, with possible targets including Russia's finance, defense, and energy sectors.
Fox Radio Simon Owen. A big win for former Minnesota Governor Jesse Ventura, jury awarding him $1.8 million in his lawsuit against the estate of the author of American Sniper, which the jury found libeled Ventura, and the 9-year-old girl hit by a crash landing plane on a Florida beach has died from her injuries. She had been walking along with her father, an Army sergeant from Fort Stewart, Georgia, who was killed in that collision on Sunday. Fox News, we report, you decide.
I'm Lex Friedman. I run my own business, so I know from experience, hiring new employees can be tough. Posting your job in one place isn't enough to find quality candidates. If you want to find the perfect hire, you need to post your job on all the top job sites, and now you can. With ZipRecruiter.com, you can post your job to 50-plus job sites, including Craigslist, LinkedIn, and Twitter, all with a single click. Find candidates in any industry nationwide. Just post once and watch your qualified candidates roll in to ZipRecruiter's easy-to-use interface. No juggling emails or calls to your office. Quickly screen candidates, rate them, and hire the right person fast. Find out today why ZipRecruiter has been used by over 200,000 businesses. And right now, our listeners can post jobs on ZipRecruiter for free by going to ZipRecruiter.com/info. That's ZipRecruiter.com/info. One more time, to try it for free, go to ZipRecruiter.com/info.
Understand.
And now it's time for the voice.
Don't know how to put this, but I'm kind of a big deal.
I want you to get up right now
and go to the window,
open it,
stick your head out and yell,
"Hayden Bond, top of the world!"
The voice of Ocala with Buddy Martin.
You know I don't speak Spanish. In English, please.
The cult of personality.
Good Tuesday afternoon. Welcome to the Voice of Ocala on a sunny, balmy Tuesday in the beautiful city of Ocala. We're coming to you live from the palatial studios of WOCA Radio at the entrance to the food court at the Paddock Mall here in Ocala. I'm Tom Schmitz. I'm joined by Ashley Peters, as she brings her microphone over so she can say hello. Hi, Ashley.
Hi, everybody. Hi, Tom.
How are you?
Pretty good.
See, you got your, like, tea or whatever it is from Starbucks there.
Yeah, and I didn't get you one.
Not a drop.
Nope.
One way. I will do, in your defense, so you did ask if I wanted anything.
Yep.
And I lied and said no, thinking that you would understand and still get me something.
I don't have money, Tom. You don't pay me.
That's a good point. That's a good point. Ashley, fresh, ready to begin a fresh new adventure in life, going to UCF. 2 weeks, huh?
Yep, 2 weeks.
Looking forward to it?
Yes, can't wait.
Is that because you can't wait to get out of Ocala, or you can't wait to get to college? Or both?
Both. Oh, my goodness.
See, you're 18. That's a problem we have in Ocala. The CEP and people like that, the business leaders here, they can't seem to figure out what to do to keep kids like yourself from leaving Ocala. What are you going to come back to Ocala when you graduate? Is that the plan, or do you have you thought that far in advance?
I don't know what I'm going to do in Ocala for a job with my degree, so no, I'm not coming back.
And therein lies the problem.
Yeah, basically.
Although you do know Lockheed Martin's here, right?
That's nice.
You know what Lockheed Martin does, right?
No idea.
You really don't know?
You got me. No, of course I know.
Of course. And what is your major?
Aerospace engineering.
And what does Lockheed Martin do?
aerospace engineering.
Okay, just checking, making sure that you said there were no jobs that you could do in Ocala. I was just checking to make sure you knew that you could do aerospace engineering right there on Maricamp.
Right, but when there's so many opportunities out in, like, Orlando and stuff like that, why would I stick around in Ocala when there are more opportunities over there?
So you do not like your hometown?
No.
Really, I mean, is it?
No, it's not bad. It's just, it's too small for me.
It's too small for you.
Mm-hmm.
So it's too homey. You don't like the relative small town ease.
Yeah, I mean, I've been here my whole life. I want to get out and see the world.
You want to see the world? Well, you don't do that your junior year on a trip abroad.
Oh, geez.
Here's the thing. I was just like you when I was 18. I could not move out fast enough. 3 days after I graduated high school, I was packed up on the way to Atlanta. Atlanta was the big city. I was going as fast as I could get there. You learn to have an appreciation for the thing. Grass always, and you've heard this, I'm sure, and you will hear it many times, the grass is always greener on the other side. Remember, when you're sitting in traffic a month, 2 months after you graduate college, you're sitting in traffic in Orlando, 5:30 in the afternoon, and looking at the prospects of not getting home until 7, that you're sitting in rush hour traffic, and in Ocala, it's called rush minute traffic.
I do hate traffic. That's very true.
It's Trivia Day to Tuesday with Tom. Today, your chance to win. I got great prizes. I got a free round of golf plus a free golf lesson from Ocala Golf Club. I got a $20 gift certificate from Bob Wines. I got 2 tickets to Historic Marion Theater. I got Mojo's gift cards. I got a value box, recipe box. I'm giving away all kind of stuff today, Ashley.
So thrilling.
I know. That's what I'm saying. All you got to do is answer a simple Trivial Pursuit question from a standard Trivial Pursuit game in the one of these 3 categories, entertainment, sports, and leisure, or geography. Entertainment, sports, and leisure, or geography. You get the question right, you'll hear this. That means you're a winner if you did it within 10 seconds. Ashley will take your name, your email address, and your phone number and tell you where to come pick up your prize. Sounds easy, right, Ashley?
Easy enough.
Nobody's won since nobody won last week.
Well, you know how it is.
They can't go against the Terminator. They got nothing. Also on today's show, Buddy Martin joins us at 4 o'clock. He what's the word I'm looking for here? He moderated the county commission debate last night between Carl Zalek, the incumbent, and Glenn Fiorella, the man running for his position. Buddy will tell us exactly what happened there. He said a pretty good turnout at the OPD community room, at the Ocala Police Department community room for that county commission debate. Plus, he's going to tell you about an Arizona doctor who tried to make a point, and the police made a point with him instead. Wait till you hear this story. And are women getting smarter faster than men? Buddy will tell us about that all in the 4 o'clock hour. Plus, tomorrow he's going to tell you today about a guest that's going to come on tomorrow. Listen up, Florida fans. Tomorrow should be a day you listen to the radio. We like that you listen every day, but tomorrow especially. Buddy's got a guest coming on that'll join us tomorrow that may answer some questions you Florida fans have, so stay tuned for that. Right here, as Buddy announces who that'll be coming up today on the show, he'll announce who it is tomorrow that he'll be interviewing. And it's around the water cooler. Buddy Martin and myself will go along. Tom James may or may not make it. He's got some prior obligations he's got to attend, but he may or may not make it. Buddy's go along today. Is the state of Florida a breeding ground for great quarterbacks? He'll tell you his take on that. And my take is, shouldn't we just let kids be kids? We'll talk about that during Go Long. But it is Trivinator Tuesday with Tom. It's your chance to go up against me, the Trivinator, to win fantastic prizes. When we get back, the first prize I'm going to give away, dinner and a movie. I'm going to give 2 passes to the Historic Marion Theater and a $10 gift card to Mojo's Gift and Catering Company to a person that can answer a trivia question. It's a standard trivia question from a standard Trivial Pursuit game in either entertainment, sports and leisure, or geography. If you get the question right, in a 10-second time limit, you'll hear this sound. Once you hear that sound, you're a winner. You give Ashley your name, your email address, and your phone number, and she'll tell you how to come pick up your prize. It is that easy to play Trivia Tuesday with Tom. Plus, Buddy Martin in the 4 o'clock hour. Are men, women getting smarter faster than men? And he'll tell you about a doctor that obviously he's a lot smarter than what he displayed, and the cops pointed that out to him. Plus, it's around the water cooler in the sports hour. All that, plus Buddy's got a surprise guest that'll be on tomorrow's show. All that you'll find out today right here on The Voice of Ocala, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local on The Source.
Hi, it's Lisa Midget with Kinetic Motion Fitness. I'm looking forward to a fun, healthy summer, and I have a few ideas that might just help you and your friends stay in shape and have fun too. Along with awesome personal training and group classes at our warm and inviting fitness studio, we also offer fitness classes at your home or business. And if you're tired of the same old, boring cake and punch party, why not let us host a hot new health trend, a fitness party at your home or office? If you're having a hard time getting to the gym this summer, because of your crazy schedule, then work out with your friends or coworkers in a private group fitness class, or host a fitness party at your home or office. We will bring you and your friends or coworkers one of our great workouts like Zumba, Piloxing, Body Bar, Yoga, Tai Chi, Boot Camp, or Zumbatomics for kids. We can even help you reach your long-term goals by meeting at your place weekly for an on-location workout. Check out our website at kmfocala.com and like us on Facebook. Kinetic Motion Fitness is located just 5 minutes from downtown Ocala near the Skylark Plaza. Kinetic Motion Fitness. We're ready when you are.
Hi, this is Lisa Midget, owner of the Properties Salon in downtown Ocala. Here in Florida, we're all about summertime fun, but along with the warm weather comes humidity, which leads to the dreaded frizzies. Are you tired of checking the weather report every morning before deciding to flat iron your hair? Sick of looking like the Lion King every day by noon? Has God just not seen fit to answer your prayers for patience and silky, frizz-free hair? Well, your troubles are over. Come to the Properties Salon for one of our hair smoothing systems. Specializing in Peter Coppola and Cezanne keratin smoothing treatments, the Properties Salon can tame your unruly locks with these formaldehyde-free formulas. And with the discount code BUDDYROCKS, you will save 20%. Not fighting the frizzies? Mention the same code BUDDYROCKS to save 20% off one of our many services such as cuts, color extensions, and manis and pedis. Gentlemen, this special is not just for the ladies. We do great cuts and color for men too. Check us out at theproperties.com for more information.
Hey, it's Tom James. If you just can't get enough of Buddy Martin talking sports on the radio all week, I have the solution for you. Check out his college football column each week on southernpigskin.com. That's southernpigskin.com. Everything you ever wanted to know about college football in the South.
Your source for the number one sports weekend, Fox Sports, only on 96.3 FM, 1370 AM.
Who would you feed if you had 50 chicken sandwiches from Chick-fil-A? WOCA and Chick-fil-A in the Paddock Mall have teamed up to reward one organization with 50 chicken sandwiches as a way of saying thanks for the great work that organization is doing in our community. And we need your help. See, there are so many great people doing great things that we need nominations. You can nominate your own organization or any organization you choose. Simply send an email to WOCA@WOCA.com. And in 350 words or less, tell us why the organization you are nominating should receive 50 free chicken sandwiches from WOCA and Chick-fil-A at the Paddock Mall. We'll review your nominations and then select one deserving organization each month. We'll announce the winner and even read the winning entry on the air. Make sure to include the contact name and phone number of the organization that you are nominating. And thanks from your friends at WOCA and Chick-fil-A in the Paddock Mall. On the next AM Ocala Live, Robin and I will be speaking to Dr. Clifford W. Bassett. He's coming up to speak to us about how to travel safely with allergies.
News Bites, the hottest news and current events are bite-sized.
And then Paul Fredrickson is coming on. He helped develop the brand names you know, like Home Depot, Dixie, Crystal Sugar, RCA, GE Consumer Electronics, and he's coming on our show to teach us how to successfully brand our own businesses.
Leroy Fleming is a poet and an inspirational speaker. He's written a book called Soul Splitting, a journey where mind, body, body and spirit questions the heart of daily living.
And then Higher Education Happenings. Mike Fallon will be in the studio. He's the Community Relations Coordinator for Webster University. He'll be here with several guests talking about education.
Have all of your legal questions answered by attorney John Fuller on Legally Yours.
And then Recovery Talk with Carrie Bone. She's a professional outreach representative for the Refuge in Ocklawaha. All of that plus Fun with Joe on the next AM Ocala Live right here on The Source, WOCA 96.3 FM.
1370 AM.
Welcome back to the Voice of Ocala Tribune Tuesday with Tom. Let's go right out to the phones, the Climate Control Source Hotline, 622-9622, and join Kathy. Kathy, how are you today?
Hi, how are you all today?
Wonderful, Kathy. Kathy, So what can we do to keep Ashley in Ocala, Kathy? Come up with something that's great about Ocala that'll make Ashley stay, Kathy.
Oh, I love Ocala. I came back after being away. I was away from, 63, came back in 77. I'd been here before since 51. It's just home. Nothing else feels like home.
There you go, Ashley. Nothing else feels like home. You have to stay now. Good job, Kathy. Kathy, you want to play Tribunator Tuesday with Tom?
Yeah, I have.
Okay,
just one question this time?
One question, and you got 10 seconds.
All right.
Geography, entertainment, or sports?
Entertainment, please.
Entertainment. Yeah, I don't think you picked a very good one, Kathy. According to the early 90s rap duo Crisscross, what will Daddy Mac make you do?
Oh, you guys, I sure didn't.
According to the
go
early
to work?
Go to work is not the correct answer. The correct answer is jump. Daddy Mac will make you jump.
Yeah, I wouldn't know that in a blue moon.
Kathy, thanks so much for playing Tribunator Tuesday with Tom.
You're welcome.
That's how you do it. You just call the Climate Control Source Hotline, 622-9622. Answer one trivia question in either geography, sports, or entertainment. Sports and leisure or entertainment. If you get out of a basic Trivial Pursuit game, you get it right, in 10 seconds you'll hear this. You hear that, you're a winner. So call the Climate Control Source Hotline at 622-9622 for your chance to win. You know, we live in the shark capital of the world, Ashley. More shark bites here than anywhere else in the world. New Smyrna Beach has more shark bites than anywhere else in the world.
I thought you were going to say Ocala, and I was going to say what, pool sharks?
No, New Smyrna Beach. Turn your mic up. There you go. New Smyrna Beach. Well, over in Australia, they know a thing or two about real shark bites. You know, they do have great whites over there. So it makes sense that an Australian company has built a device to scare off sharks. The company's made its way to Florida to sell the device, and they call it Shark Shield. They announced in a press release that they would start selling it in U.S. markets in the Tampa Bay area, targeting those who frequent the shark-filled waters.
Okay, what's your name, please?
The way it's purported to work is Shark Shield emits an electrical field that causes a shark within a meter or so to spasm and flee the area. So they're giving a little electric shock, little taser to the shark saying, get away from me. There are different devices depending on the activity, range from $599 to $699. I don't think many people are going to pay $699 for shark repellent. It's one of those things that you wish you had it after you got bit by a shark. $699, I think I'll take my chances. I don't know. Let's go to the phone lines. Who do we have, Ashley?
We have Linnell.
Linnell, hi, how are you today? Linnell, are you there? Is she there? There she is. We had to push buttons. We had all kind of buttons that we had to push to get you here.
All right, very good.
It's kind of like the transporter in Star Trek. You know, you got to push the right buttons, or you'll get lost out in limbo somewhere.
That works.
Linnell, how's your day going today?
It's great, thank you.
It's a wonderful day today. Beautiful, a little hot for me, but there's a breeze, so it's not that bad of a Central Florida summer day.
It's beautiful.
All right, let's play Tribunator Tuesday with Tom Linnell. This is your chance to win two tickets to the Historic Marion Theater plus a $10 gift card to Mojo's Grill and Catering Company. Pick a category, geography, sports and leisure, or entertainment.
Geography. I'm going to pick entertainment and hope it's not a rap question.
Let's go entertainment. Who plays the guitar solo in Michael Jackson's hit Beat It?
Oh, Eric Clapton.
Eric Clapton is not correct. The correct answer is Eddie Van Halen. Eddie Van Halen played it.
Thank you.
Hey, Linnell, thanks for playing Terminator Tuesday with Tom. She asked for a non-rap question. I gave her a Michael Jackson question. That was close to non-rap. I mean, Michael Jackson never did rap, so, you know. It's time to play Terminator Tuesday with Tom. 622-9622 for your chance to win.
Thank you for calling the Voice of Ocala with Buddy Martin. Who is this, please?
Two tickets to the Historic Marion Theater plus a $10 gift card to Mojo's Grill and Catering Company. Let's go back out to the lines and welcome him, Tom. Tom, how are you?
Good, Tom. How's it going?
You know, if I got a better Tom, I'd have a better... Oh, wait, I do have a great name. That's enough. Yeah, that's good. It's good.
How'd you do this weekend in Tampa?
You don't want to know. You don't want to know, Tom.
That bad, huh?
No, well, I played. It was a $100,000 guaranteed 2-day tournament. Made it to the second day and took a exit within the first hour and a half of the second day. I got the same thing. I finished about 100 people from the money, and I got the same thank you from the host of the tournament as the guy that went out the first guy to go out on Saturday at 8 in the morning. Hey, thanks for playing. We appreciate your money. Somebody else is going to spend it. So, but other than that, you know, you can't complain. I played good poker for 7.5 hours, and some guy had to get lucky to beat me. What's the old Phil Hellmuth line? If it wasn't for luck, he'd be the best poker player in the world.
Absolutely.
So, Tom, you want to play Trivia Tuesday with Tom?
Sure. About sports and leisure.
Sports and leisure. What vowel is the only one not in the top row of a standard QWERTY keyboard letter?
Hey.
A is correct. It's the first letter in line 2. Tom, congratulations. Stay on the line. Ashley will get your name and email address and everything. Tell you how to pick up your prize. Thanks for playing. There it is. Tom wins just that easy. Trivia Night of Tuesday with Tom, just like that. He's a winner. Let me tell you this.
Hi, can I get your last name?
If you live in South Daytona, you're pretty lucky right now. Especially if you live in the Spanish Villas apartment complex in South Daytona. The reason why? An arsonist lit the apartment complex on fire while residents were at home.
IX or IS?
Arthur Avery didn't find who he was looking for, a man by the name of Ted. So he just started flashing gasoline all around the apartment complex and got set it on fire. The fire burned 2 front doors and a mattress before working its way up higher. And eventually, they could see flames all the way up on the second floor. Only problem was, Arthur Avery didn't set just the apartments on fire. He set himself on fire, too. The suspected arsonist was found laying over in the grass after being put out by residents of the apartment complex with second and third degree burns over 80% of his body. He's now in the burn treatment center in Orlando, under arrest for arson and attempted murder, 11 different charges. Way to go, smart guy. Wow, really? Splash gasoline on everything and then set your own self on fire. Way to compound your idiocy. Not only are you an idiot, but you're a compound idiot. Let's go back out to the phone lines. Who do we have, Ashley?
We have Tyler on the line.
Hi, Tyler. How are you doing?
Doing good today.
Tyler, give me a reason why you should stay in Ocala. If you're 18, 19 years old, give me a reason to stay in Ocala.
I can't really think of one.
See, that's a pro. Tyler, you must be 18 or 19 years old.
Yeah, yes. I am a bit on the biased side.
See, there you go. See, that's a problem we have in our city. Our city leaders need to figure out a way to keep you guys in town instead of letting you get out of town. Let's play Trivinator Tuesday with Tom. You want geography, sports, and leisure, or entertainment?
Entertainment.
Entertainment. Let's go. Random card. What chart topper was sung by a group of musicians who dubbed themselves USA for Africa?
I have no idea.
I don't believe that was an actual song. I have no idea. I don't believe it. Thank you.
It was We Are the World.
Ashley's right. It was We Are the World. She's not eligible, though. We are the world. We are the children. Yeah. There was a great parody of that song done by Chris Rock. It was hilarious. Hey, thanks for playing, Tyler. Tribunator Tuesday with Tom. Just like that, you answer questions. You get them right. You get them right. We're going to take one more caller before the break. We'll try to squeeze in one more caller before the break.
I'm sorry, can you repeat that, please? I didn't catch your name.
I'm talking too loud, and Ashley's having problems hearing names. So, okay. Who do we got? Jim? Let's go to the phone line and talk to Jim. Hi, Jim. How are you?
I'm good.
Jim, what? Give me a suggestion on how to keep the 18, 19, and 20-year-olds here in Ocala.
Well, I'm a little older than that, but one of my favorite things is about being in this area is I like to fish. You can't live in a much better place than that. Maybe they could promote some fishing tournaments with younger people.
Well, you know, that's a good thing. The ecotourism, promote the outdoors. We have some fantastic outdoors here in our area.
It's amazing.
It is amazing. Jim, let's play Trivia Tuesday with Tom. You want geography, sports and leisure, or entertainment?
I'm going to roll the dice with entertainment.
Entertainment. A lot of entertainment people today.
So well, I got a lot of them right here. You already did, so I'm gonna cross my fingers here.
What show features President David Palmer?
No idea.
No idea. That was not the name of a song or the name of a president. Yeah. That was the name of the president in Kiefer Sutherland's show, 24. 24. Hey, thanks for playing today. So, it's not, you know, we're going to take a break. After the break, you can call us at 622-9622 for your chance to win. I've already given away two tickets to Historic Marion Theater plus a $10 gift card to Mojo's. Right now I'm trying to give away a round of golf at Ocala Golf Club plus one free lesson from the golf pro Chris Alley at Ocala Golf Club. That's a $70 value, and I'm giving it away if you can answer one question correctly. We'll do it on the other side of the break right here on Trivinator Tuesday with Tom. All you got to do is call the Climate Control Source Hotline at 622-9622 when we get back from break. And you can play Trivinator Tuesday with Tom. We already have one winner. Will you be the second one? Can't wait to find out. On the other side, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local on The Source.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And so is State Farm agent Angie Lewis, working hard to serve her community as a citizen and insurance agent. Angie wants to help you as you adjust your insurance needs to your life. From everything to helping educate your teen driver to protecting your family against everyday risk. She wants to change the way you perceive insurance by developing relationships with her clients, which is why Angie and her staff are proud to be a part of so many good causes in Ocala. In turn, she has chosen to single out those who step up as leaders. Each month on The Voice of Ocala, Angie spotlights a good neighbor, saluting those who give exceptional service or do random acts of kindness to others. For this, Angie was written up in State Farm's National Magazine. Angie also supports local businesses with a regular Biz Buzz. The Angie Lewis State Farm Agency is located at 1122 Northeast 36th Avenue, where visitors are always welcome and the coffee pot is always on.
Ultimate summer staycation, just minutes from downtown Ocala, but miles away from the ordinary. A summer sports or summer golf membership at Golden Ocala Golf and Equestrian Club is your all-inclusive ticket to a summer filled with activities and fun from June through September. A summer membership at Golden Ocala opens the door to a world-class setting. Is golf your game? Is tennis your passion? Or is lounging poolside more your speed? Want to get in shape? Work out in the state-of-the-art fitness center and then relax and unwind in the sauna or the spa. Summer members also have use of the Equestrian Center at Golden Ocala, offering full board and paddock, impeccable trails, and a jumping ring for riders of all ages. Summer memberships are going fast. So visit goldenocala.com and explore the options. Golden Ocala Golf and Equestrian Club. This summer, you can live there and still play here.
1370 WOCA.
We are the source, WOCA.
Fox News Radio, I'm Lillian Wu. Growing international condemnation of Russia a dozen days after the downing of a Malaysia jetliner allegedly by pro-Russian separatists. President Obama expected to unleash a new round of sanctions, which he'll talk about today.
The European Union expected to impose broad sanctions on Russia for the first time since the crisis in Ukraine began, with possible targets including Russia's finance, defense, and energy sectors.
Fox Radio, Simon Owen. A big win for former Minnesota Governor Jesse Ventura, jury awarding him $1.8 million in his lawsuit against the estate of the author of American Sniper, which the jury found libeled Ventura. And the 9-year-old girl hit by a crash landing plane on a Florida beach has died from her injuries. She'd been walking along with her father, an Army sergeant from Fort Stewart, Georgia, who was killed in that collision on Sunday. Fox News, we report, you decide.
I'm Lex Friedman. I run my own business, so I know from experience, hiring new employees can be tough. Posting your job in one place isn't enough to find quality candidates. If you want to find the perfect hire, you need to post your job on all the top job sites, and now you can. With ZipRecruiter.com, you can post your job to 50-plus job sites, including Craigslist, LinkedIn, and Twitter, all with a single click. Find candidates in any industry nationwide. Just post once and watch your qualified candidates roll in to ZipRecruiter's easy-to-use interface. No juggling emails or calls to your office. Quickly screen candidates, rate them, and hire the right person fast. Find out today why ZipRecruiter has been used by over 200,000 businesses. And right now, our listeners can post jobs on ZipRecruiter for free by going to ZipRecruiter.com/info. That's ZipRecruiter.com/info. One more time. To try it for free, go to ZipRecruiter.com.
Hi, I'm Yvette, and I'm here to tell you a few things about ABC Frederick's Appliance. They sell not only new, but used guaranteed appliances. When you call ABC Frederick's Appliance, they will provide service on what they sell and any appliances that you own. ABC Frederick's Appliance is located in Bellevue, right over the railroad tracks. Call 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. ABC Frederick's Appliance.
Let's face it, nowadays it can be hard to find American-made products, and that's something that Cabinet Sales of North Florida is well aware of. That's why they're an authorized dealer of Wellborn Cabinetry, family-owned and American-made since 1961. Cabinet Sales of North Florida is your answer for complete turnkey kitchen remodels and whole house cabinetry. Their cabinets are finished with solvent-based enamels for a long-lasting finish that's second to none. Available in an incredible selection of door styles and colors to choose from to turn your dream kitchen into a reality. In-house design and drawing services are available. Come by and see our displays for yourself at the Floors of the Villages, 3935 County Road 216 in Oxford, or Exquisite Design Kitchen and Bath in Bellevue, right across the street from the Bellevue Library. So whether you're looking for bookcases, kitchen, bath, or outdoor kitchen, Cabinet Sales of North Florida is your one-stop source of quality cabinets. For a free estimate, call 352-427-2647. That's 352-427-2647. Cabinet Sales of North Florida.
Now is the time to take advantage of Florida Credit Union's CD specials. Our 36-month CD comes in at 1.26% APY. A 24-month is working for you at 1.0% APY. And our 12-month at 0.75% APY. All CD rate specials require $10,000 minimum. With friendly service and rates like these, it's not hard to see why Florida Credit Union has your CD options covered. Florida Credit Union, connecting your money to your life. Call 352-237-8222 for more information. Must act by 1/15/14.
And I'm feeling good. I'm feeling good. Fish in the sea, you know how I feel.
River. We're back on the Voice of Ocala. Tribunate Tuesday with Tom. That right there, that's Bublé, right?
Is Michael Bublé.
Yeah, that reminded me of this morning. I was watching the Today Show. Tony Bennett, 80-something years old, just made a new jazz album with Lady Gaga. All really? Jazz music from the 40s. Gershwin, Cole Porter, music like that.
I'll just have to go find that for
and
you.
Lady Gaga says that she would prefer singing that music than the stuff she sings now.
Well, why doesn't she?
Well, they made a whole album. I could get into that because I'm a huge fan of jazz music, so I could get into that. Let's go out to the phone and talk to Blanche. Blanche, hi, how are you today?
I'm just fine, thank you.
Blanche, you a big Lady Gaga fan?
Well, I have seen her, but I wouldn't call myself a fan, but she's lovely at what she does, so that's just fine.
But would you check out an album that her and Tony Bennett did together?
Well, since I'm 90 years old, I think Tony Bennett's just marvelous. Of course I would.
Tony Bennett is just marvelous. And I think you're being a little tongue-in-cheek about 90 years old, Blanche.
No. My husband and I came here 70 years ago from Kentucky.
Wow.
Yes. We've seen a lot of changes in 70 years.
You have. Okay, let's play Trivinator Tuesday with Tom.
All right.
You want geography, sports, and leisure, or entertainment?
I am going to go out on a limb and do geography.
Wow. Okay. How many great pyramids are at Giza?
Seven.
Seven is not correct. The answer is three.
Oh!
Three, but thanks for playing today. You have a wonderful
Bye-bye.
Day. Blanche gave it a shot, trying to win a round of golf at Ocala Municipal Golf Club and a lesson, free lesson from Chris Halley, the golf pro there. That's a $70 value with a round of golf and the lesson. All you have to do is call the Climate Control Source Hotline at 622-9622 for your chance to win. Ashley, if something, you have an emergency, who are you supposed to call?
The police.
What number are you supposed to call?
911.
Right, 911 if you have an emergency. The police or the fire department is then dispatched to your house and they help you deal with your emergency, right?
Right.
So when 54-year-old Lynette Ray Simpson called the police, she had an emergency. She was worried about something. So the Enid, Oklahoma Police Department arrived at her house, and she said, "I'm glad you came." She invited the cops in and showed him a tin that she had inside of her house and said, "This is my meth. I think it's been laced with something. I'm freaking out." She called 911 literally to tell the police that her meth, she was worried her meth was laced with something and wanted to report it. She invited the officer into his house and told him she had a meth in a tin container in the kitchen and it was laced with something.
CJ, I'm sorry.
The officer asked Sampson to show him the tin. She did. Inside he found a light bulb used to smoke meth and two small bags that contained the drugs. Sampson then walked into her living room, sat down, and began to sweat and hallucinate. She told the officer she had recently smoked meth and asked not to be arrested. Guess what, Ashley?
Tell me, Tom.
She was arrested.
Oh, really?
Once, Enid, Oklahoma Police Captain Jack Morris said, "Once you think you've seen it all, something new will surprise you. It's sad people who utilize these drugs don't realize how it affects them and what they can do to you." She called the police to say her meth was laced with something, and she was freaking out.
That's one of those times where you just don't call the cops and you try and figure it out for yourself.
How about this?
Don't smoke meth?
Don't smoke meth!
Very true.
You're 54. What is a 54-year-old doing smoking meth?
Having fun.
Stop it! Scott at the phone lines, talk to CJ. CJ, what's up?
Hey, what's going on, Tom?
CJ, can you believe this woman, 54 years old, called the police and said, "Look, my meth's tainted with something. Can you come check it out for me?"
I mean, people make all sorts of awesome decisions when they're on that stuff.
They did awesome, awesome decisions. You're entirely correct. CJ, how's your day going, pal?
It's going good. Working.
Hadn't run into you a while. I got to run into you coming soon. I haven't seen you in been 3 or 4 months since I last saw you. At one of our local businesses. We frequent local businesses and give our money to local businesses. We like local businesses around the area.
Gotta support the local economy.
CJ, let's play Trivinator Tuesday with Tom. You want geography, sports, and leisure, or entertainment?
Entertainment.
Everybody's going with entertainment today. Entertainment, let's go.
It's because you're so entertaining, Tom.
Who played John Belushi, Curly Howard, and The Thing? What actor have played John Belushi, Curly Howard, and The Thing?
Michael Chiklis.
That's correct. CJ Michael Chiklis is the correct answer. You just won one round of golf to Ocala Municipal Golf Course and a lesson, one free golf lesson from Chris Halley, the pro. Now, CJ, if I remember right, golf is something you do every now and then, correct?
Every now and then. I'll go out and hit the links.
Well, you can get maybe this lesson will help you go out more than every now and then.
I hope so. I'm looking forward to it.
All right, CJ, hang on the line. Let Ashley get all your information so I can get this prize to you. Thanks for playing Trivinator Tuesday with Tom.
Thanks, Tom.
Yep. Just that easy. Okay. CJ won. All you got to do is call Climate Control Source Hotline, 622-9622, for your chance to win. Next, we're going to give away a $20 gift certificate to Bob Wines. It's worth $20 worth of plants from Bob Wines Community Gardens and a $10 gift card to Mojo's Grill and Catering Company. All you have to do is call in the Climate Control Source Hotline at 622-9622. Answer a trivia question from a standard Trivial Pursuit game in either one of these three categories, geography, sports, and leisure entertainment. You'll hear this sound. If you hear that sound, you're a winner. It's that easy. Call the Climate Control Source Hotline, 622-9622. For your chance to win a $20 gift certificate to Bob Wine's Camellia Gardens and a $10 gift card to Mojo's Grill and Catering Company. That's a $30 value. All you have to do is answer one question correctly, and you're a winner. 622-9622. You know, I save some of these stories because you just have to have a Florida story in there, right?
Mm-hmm.
I saw this story over the weekend, and I said, are you serious about this story? And they were. It's out there. Melbourne, West Melbourne, Florida, down south. Julius Lupowitz was pulled over by a police officer Thursday in West Melbourne for driving over the speed limit. He was speeding. The officer was going to give him a speeding ticket. While the officer was in his car giving him the speeding ticket, Lupowitz came up with a fabulous idea of how to get out of the speeding ticket, Ashley. But he didn't drive off. You know, most people, they decide they'll run, right? He didn't do that. No, Lupowitz came up with a much more ingenious plan to get out of the speeding ticket. He didn't film the cop doing something stupid like people try to do. No, Lupowitz, once again, utilized 911. But not to report his meth had been tainted. Lupowitz called 911 and said he was watching someone get murdered. He said, there's definitely someone going to get shot. Please, please. The corner of Wingate and Hollywood, you know, the area where he was pulled over. A man said, there's a man with a gun. I see him looking at me, but I don't think he sees me on my cell phone. I swear I'm so scared I might kill myself. Please. Police officers were dispatched to the scene. But not the officer who had pulled Lupowitz over. The officers responded if it was real. They didn't know any different until they got there. 911 dispatchers, in the meantime, tracked down the name of the caller, announced it over the police radio, which alerted the officer standing next to Lupowitz. Our officer was standing at the door of Mr. Lupowitz's vehicle and realized at that point that this was the same person that was making the 911 calls. Lupowitz, instead of a $200 speeding ticket, now faces a felony charge with a 5-year maximum prison sentence.
Sounds like a special kind of stupid.
I mean, you got to pay to be that kind of stupid, don't you?
I would think so.
The man's getting a speeding ticket in a split decision. He says, best way to get out of this speeding ticket is call 911 and say, I'm watching somebody about to get shot. They'll call the officer writing my ticket away. Because they don't have more than one officer in that area.
Oh, no, of course not.
You know, in a town the size of Melbourne. So he was surprised when the officer stayed put. The other officer responded. So they arrested him for making felony false reporting. Charged him with a myriad of charges. Charged him with 7 different things, all of which hold a maximum of 5 years in prison. Way to go, brain dead.
I think I would have taken the ticket. I don't know about you, Tom.
Yeah. $200 speeding ticket now with lawyer's fees and everything, he's probably looking at $10,000, $15,000.
Special kind of stupid.
That's felony stupid.
Very.
That's why I got charged with felonies. So. Like our good friend, Police Chief Greg Graham in the Ocala Police Department says, if it wasn't for them, you know, dumb criminals, give him job security. This is a special kind of dumb this guy was.
They also give us things to talk about on the radio.
I mean, what about, I think I'll call 911 and say there's a shooting about to happen. Do you think it's a good idea when you're getting a speeding ticket?
Nothing.
Because you're already in the system. The cops writing you a ticket. They know it's you right there at that same corner. They were able to figure it out while the cop was still standing next to it. Way to go, brain dead.
See, my solution for getting out of a speeding ticket would be work up some waterworks and cry.
Girls just cry. That's what y'all do. And it works so
it
well.
It works.
It does work. It worked. I've seen it work so many times. I've been with, when I was in college, we'd be riding down the road with girls. They get pulled over for speeding tickets, waterworks. Okay, ma'am, I'm just going to give you a warning this time. And away they'd go. We're going to take a break. When we come back, maybe we'll squeeze in one more caller on Trivinated Tuesday with Tom. Hey, coming up in the 4 o'clock hour, Buddy Martin joins the show. He's going to talk about last night he moderated the county commission debate between Carl Zalek and Glenn Fiorella. He'll tell us what took place in the Ocala Police Department community room. Plus, an Arizona doctor. Wait till you find out about this guy. This is a special kind of stupid, too, this guy. Plus, are women getting smarter faster than men? Buddy has a story about that. All that, plus around the water cooler. Buddy Martin and I both go long. Coming up right here on a Tuesday version of The Voice of Ocala, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local on The Source.
Regions Bank has big bank ability, but possesses small bank agility. Utilizing tools like Raymond Andrews and his team of 6 mortgage experts with 100 years of experience in the mortgage industry and 50 years experience as members of the Regions Bank team. Mortgage lending is personal and important, and you deserve someone that will lead you through a positive process. Raymond and his team use local mortgaging processes like local appraisers and local closing to help you have a positive experience, and they habla Espanol as well. So whether you need a conventional, FHA, USDA, or VA loan, or you even need a construction loan, the mortgage team of your local Regions Bank has the knowledge and experience to guide you through the process. So contact Raymond Andrews and his team of mortgage experts at 352-854-4104. That's 352-854-4104. Regions Bank, it's time to expect more. Are you in the process of planning your wedding reception? Or are you planning that birthday party for someone special? Or maybe you're just looking to throw a party for yourself? Are you in charge of this year's company outing and looking for something fresh and fun to do? Well, KT Entertainment is your answer to all those questions. We provide music, trivia, and karaoke for everybody's enjoyment. If you would like to get in touch with KT Entertainment and find out about our competitive prices, call us at 352-512-2611. That's 352-512-2611. Or you can find us on the web at ktforfun.com. That's kt4fun.com. So remember, whether it's a wedding reception, a party, or a company outing, it's KT Entertainment for all your karaoke, trivia, or musical needs.
Hey, Matt, I know Sunrise Automotive does auto stuff, but I need some tires for my truck. Can you recommend someone?
Yes, I can. We do that.
No, I mean, I need them installed and balanced and all that.
Yep, we do that.
Well, my son needed his windows tinted.
Yep, we do that,
I need too. My seat replaced.
Yep, we do that, too.
I need a new roofline and a new spoiler and a new
truck. Yep, we can even do that, too.
Okay, I get it. I suppose you can also do a radio show, too, huh?
Well, as a matter of fact, join me every Monday at 10 for auto repair with personal care here on The Source.
Of course you do.
The weather is brought to you by MyFWC.com. Safe boating is no accident. A mix of sun and clouds today with a couple of showers and a thunderstorm later on today. High 89 to 92. There'll be a shower or thunderstorm around this evening otherwise. Partly cloudy skies tonight. Low 73 to 77. And tomorrow we have times of sun and clouds with a couple of showers and a thunderstorm. High 91 to 93. From the Florida Weather Center, I'm Stephanie Omo.
Now is the time to take advantage of Florida Credit Union's CD specials. Our 36-month CD comes in at 1.26% APY. A 24-month is working for you at 1.0% APY. And our 12-month at 0.75% APY. All CD rate specials require $10,000 minimum. With friendly service and rates like these, it's not hard to see why Florida Credit Union has your CD options covered. Florida Credit Union, connecting your money to your life. Call 352-237-8222 for more information. Must act by 1/15/14.
Good credits, bad credits. It's none of our business because we're not an auto dealer. We're not a bank. We're not your mother. We're OcalaForSale.com, Marion County's marketplace for cars, trucks, and SUVs. We've got thousands of sellers standing by to take your call. No middleman. But hurry, don't walk, don't run. Just sit down and log on to OcalaForSale.com.
Prices and inventory change daily. Offer does not include dealer upcharge. Undercutting, rust proofing, factory surcharge, or delivery fee. See website for details.
Hi, I'm Buddy Martin. Don't touch that dial. I'll be along in just a moment here after Tom and the Terminator, right here on the Voice of Ocala, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, the source.
In olden days, a glimpse of stocking was looked down as something shocking. Now heaven knows.
Authors too, who once knew better words, now only use four-letter words, writing prose. Anything goes.
Told you. That new album, that new collaboration by Lady Gaga and Tony Bennett, it's going to really be great. That's Lady Gaga and Tony Bennett right there. Anything Goes is the name of that song. Told you, Ashley.
Hardly sounds like her, really.
It's Lady Gaga singing jazz. It's completely different than anything you've ever heard her sing before.
She has a beautiful voice.
She's a very talented woman, and singing jazz with Tony Bennett, I like the fit. I like the fit.
They work well together, I gotta say.
They're gonna make they videotaped the whole thing. They're gonna make a documentary movie about it and everything. So it's really gonna be an event. September 28th is when the album drops. But they've released this single out. Anything Goes is already released now. So really looking forward to that. It's been a great Tribunator Tuesday with Tom today. Had two winners. Who'd we have? We had Tom and
CJ.
So two winners today. Buddy Martin coming up an hour or two, as you just heard. He said he'll be right around the corner. He's going to have he's going to tell us about him being the moderator last night at the county commission debate, Carl Zalek and Glenn Fiorella, at the Ocala Police Department Community Room. He's going to tell us what both candidates had to say. One of the things they talked about was jail privatization. He's going to tell us how they came down on that, either one of them, how both of them felt about that. And, of course, taxes. You know, taxes are a big deal in this town. Nobody wants taxes, but somehow we got to pay for government.
Does anyone want taxes?
Nobody wants taxes, but you also want good roads, and you also want good sewer lines and everything like that, too. So some taxes are needed to pay for government. I don't want exorbitant taxes. I don't want a big government that thinks it needs to tax me to death so it can just get larger and larger. But the government size we have in this county, we have to pay for. We have to pay for the police in this county. We have to pay for the fire department in this county. We have to pay for road upkeep in this county. We have to pay for, you know, schools in this county. Those things we have to pay for. The only way you pay for those is through taxes. If the cost of living goes up, it stands to reason every now and then taxes have to go up. I know that's not something my Republican brethren like to hear, but pull your head out of your rear ends and understand eventually taxes have to increase because the cost of running the government increases. I don't like it just as much as you don't like it, but the reality of the situation is you can't operate a 2013 governmental budget, even as small as the one we have here in Marion County, on a 1970s mentality of no taxes.
Very true. Very true.
You just can't do it. Stop being an ostrich, pull your head out of the sand, and realize reality. So we'll find out what Glenn Fiorello and County Commissioner Carl Zalek had to say on that. Plus, you'll find out about an Arizona doctor that is a special kind of stupid. Buddy will tell you about that. I had that as one of my stories on one of my stupid stories, but Buddy can probably make it sound a whole lot better, this Arizona doctor that's a special kind of moronic. Plus, are women getting smarter faster than men? Of course not. Telling you that right now, but Buddy may tell me I'm wrong. We'll find out next in Hour 2 of the Voice of Ocala. 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local on The Source.
And although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home.
Are you a business owner looking for a new and innovative way to reach consumers by thinking outside of the box? Well, here's a great new idea that thinks inside the box. Value Box. Value Box is a beautiful recipe box that features your business's profile on the front of recipe cards with a personal recipe on the back. With Value Box, a business's name can stay in front of their customers for years. They also offer an app for your iPhone or iPad for those who cook in the 21st century. So if it's time for your business to think outside the box to reach consumers, start by thinking inside the box with Value Box. For more information, you can contact Chuck Henderson of Value Box USA at 352-433-5301. That's 352-433-5301. Or by email, chuck@valueboxusa.com.
Hi, I'm Tom Ingram, CEO of Gateway Bank, inviting you to drop by our main office on Silver Springs Boulevard every Friday from 3 to 6 p.m. for the Community Gazette, a three-hour show focusing on our favorite community to live and work, Ocala, Marion County. Come join us with the voice of Ocala, Buddy Martin, in the new old-fashioned bank radio studio as we discuss a variety of interesting topics on the Community Gazette on WOCA, The Source.
Right on the southwestern corner of the square sits one of the finest dining establishments in Florida, Mark's Prime Steakhouse and Seafood Restaurant. Mark's offers big city dining amenities in a charming and small town setting. It's a rare treat to experience both the ambiance and the exquisite cuisine in a friendly atmosphere. Ocala's finest restaurant serves the finest beef, the freshest seafood, premium wines, and naturally fresh vegetables. From valet parking to splendid service, Mark's offers the complete package. Check it out today. Mark's Prime Seafood and Steakhouse Restaurant.
Need a car? Need financing? Need somebody to cut through the red tape and send you rolling down the highway? Prestige Auto Sales is the place to go. Got great credit and just prefer a quality pre-owned car at a fair price from somebody you can trust? Prestige Auto Sales is the place to go. Want to avoid high pressure to feel appreciated and be able to choose from a wide selection of AutoCheck and Carfax certified vehicles? Prestige Auto Sales is the place to go. Prestige Auto Sales in Ocala and Bellevue. Prestige. It's all there in our name.
Look who just walked in the room, Joel Wiesner from What's Up Ocala. Hey, Joel, I'm looking for something to do this weekend. You got any ideas?
Absolutely. Check out our event calendar online at www.whatsupocala.com, and there is plenty of events there for you. Daily news updates to event reviews and magazine articles.
Really?
We've organized it all in one place online for you to cut through all of the hassle of finding something to do this weekend. We have a daily event calendar, a bi-monthly magazine, and we also do daily news articles.
All right, Joel, that's perfect. Thanks so much.
Yeah, whatsupocala.com.
On this episode of What Not to Do, brought to you by
Mike Scott Plumbing. If water runs through it, we do it.
Okay, easy. All right, set her down. Over there. Easy.
What are you doing?
Oh, honey, you're home early. Nothing.
Really? Because it looks to me like you've torn up the entire yard with this giant tractor.
Not all of it. There is a small section over there I didn't
get. That's not even funny. Why are you tearing up my yard?
Well, the sprinkler head broke.
So you thought it was a good idea to fix it with a huge tractor?
Well, not at first, but then when I tried to fix it, I hit the main line. Thought it would be a good idea if...
You thought all of this was a good idea? Here's an idea. Why don't you just call Mike Scott Plumbing? It's that easy. In fact, let me help you out with that. 237-2888.
But it's the weekend.
I know. They don't charge extra for nights, weekends, or holidays. Remember the commercials? If water runs through it, they do it. And they're already on their way. So get this monstrosity out of my yard.
On next week's episode of What Not to Do.
A crane? Really?
How good does it get?
Golf has long been considered to be sport's most prestigious game, and WOCA has your connection to everything in the golf world. Every first and third Thursday at 10 a.m., tune in for Let's Talk Golf with your host, PGA professional and teacher to the stars, Jim Beckett, and operations manager for the links of Spruce Creek South, Darren Irwin, right here on The Source.
A garden, and we've got a show for you called You've Got a Garden with your host, Master Gardener Carol Ann Baldwin. Carol Ann answers your questions about your flowers, your veggies, your grass, your trees, even questions about your bugs. And she's only on WOCA, so don't miss Carol Ann Baldwin and You've Got a Garden each Tuesday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. right here on WOCA The Source.
You're listening to WOCA Ocala. Broadcasting from the Paddock Mall Studios, this is WOCA, Ocala, Gainesville, The Villages, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source.
Fox News Radio, I'm Karen McHugh. President Obama has announced new penalties by the U.S. and the EU on Russia targeting their energy and financial sectors.
The sanctions we're announcing today will have an even bigger bite.
The increased sanctions are in response to the downing of Malaysia Flight 17 over Ukraine. Israeli tanks have knocked out Gaza's one and only power plant. That could leave the region without lights for weeks. The State Department urges both sides to avoid hitting civilian targets.
We certainly urge all parties to respect the civilian nature of schools and medical facilities. These facilities, which serve as shelters.
Spokeswoman Jen Psaki, the body of a teenage stowaway, was found inside the wheel well of an Air Force plane in Germany. The Pentagon isn't yet sure where he came from.
The deceased was an adolescent black male, possibly of African origin. The aircraft had just returned from supporting Africa Command operations with stops in a few countries.
Spokesman Admiral John Kirby, Fox News. We report, you decide.
I'm Lex Friedman. I run my own business, so I know from experience, hiring new employees can be tough. Posting your job in one place isn't enough to find quality candidates. If you want to find the perfect hire, you need to post your job on all the top job sites, and now you can. With ZipRecruiter.com, you can post your job to 50-plus job sites, including Craigslist, LinkedIn, and Twitter, all with a single click. Find candidates in any industry nationwide. Just post once and watch your qualified candidates roll in to ZipRecruiter's easy-to-use interface. No juggling emails or calls to your office. Quickly screen candidates, rate them, and hire the right person fast. Find out today why ZipRecruiter has been used by over 200,000 businesses. And right now, our listeners can post jobs on ZipRecruiter for free by going to ZipRecruiter.com/info. That's ZipRecruiter.com/info. One more time. To try it for free, go to ZipRecruiter.com/.
Yes, it's time again for Buddy Martin. Call him up and tell him what you're thinking. But be kind because he's doing the best he can.
I'm just sick of all the amateur stuff, you know? I mean, like, if I'm paying top dollar, I want a little production value, you know? Like some editing, transition, something, some music.
Don't worry, we didn't leave you.
He's gone? He's not gone! That's the whole point! He's never gone!
Our bosses say we gotta stay.
Check out the name tag. You're in my world now, Grandma.
Bow to your sensei. Bow to your sensei!
It's time for the second hour of The Voice of Ocala.
Hoo-ah!
You ever come across anything like time travel?
Come on, stick around. It's free.
If you win, you win. If you lose, you still win.
Said, it's hour two of the program, sometimes known as The Voice of Ocala. Tom Schmitz carried you the first hour. The Terminator was in the studio today. Hope you enjoyed that. And Buddy Martin, I'm picking up from here. We'll have 2 hours now of jam up radio, as they say down south.
Yeah.
And
you didn't get pulled over today, did you, and call 911 to try to get out of a speeding ticket, did you?
No, what should I have?
No, well, you know, I just didn't want you to do what Lupowitz did.
Okay. All right. No, I didn't do that, but I do got some really good news, and you're going to love this. This is a story you're going to love.
Can't wait.
I'm not going to tell you. I'll have to wait and find out. Today on the program, as Tom said last hour, we've got we'll talk about the County Commission debate last night, which I moderated at the Ocala Police Department Community Room. Glenn Fiorella, candidate, incumbent Carl Zalek. And I don't know, it lasted a little over an hour, and we had some interesting discussions. I'll get into that a little bit later on in the show. We had big news yesterday, by the way, that the Ladies Professional Golf Association, LPGA, will open its season in 2015 at Golden, Ocala. And the kickoff of their season there. So we'll talk more about that. We'll get some folks on from Golden, Ocala to talk about that. That's always good when big-time events come to our
The Coach team. Golf Championship brought to you by R&L Carriers.
Outstanding. Looking forward to that. I don't know about the story, how you guys out there are going to feel about it, but there's some scientific indication that women are getting smarter faster than men. And, of course, they're already pretty much smarter than men, so it's a little frightening. If they keep riding the gap, us guys are in trouble. But we'll discuss that today. In sports, big news for us is that the athletic director from the University of Florida, Jeremy Foley, joins our show tomorrow at 3:03. We don't normally do sports in that hour, but Jeremy was only available during that time, and we've been trying to line this interview up for a couple of weeks, and we said, sure, we'll take it. So at 3:03 tomorrow, we'll have the athletic director at Florida. We have some questions to ask him, obviously, about the new face of college football, the new playoff system, the eight-game schedule for conference, the coaching situation at Florida, and, of course, the fan base and the difficulties all universities are having. I read a story, by the way, over the weekend. I've had it for about a month. I just got around to it. Michigan is having a terrible time with their fans. The big house is kind of crumbling up there from the story I read.
Really?
Yeah. You think Florida's having problems. What do you hear this story? I'll bring it in here tomorrow. Next day we'll talk about it. But Michigan is really struggling with some of the issues they've got. Somewhat like Florida's, but not altogether the same. So we'll talk about that tomorrow. Our go-along today on our Around the Water Cooler, Tom's going to talk about Let Kids Be Kids. Is that about this show or?
No, not
the kids on the show, huh? And I'm going to talk about something that kind of came to me during the weekend while I was at the Brantley quarterback camp, and that is the rich heritage of quarterbacks in our state of Florida and in Gainesville. And we'll talk about that, about the Brantley camp and the people who were there and Jeff Driscoll and his part in this. And we'll break that down for you in my go long during sports. And also, Tom James' favorite basketball team finally got a coach today. took him long enough, and they do have one. So all that coming up today on the program, plus a big surprise for Tom. He's going to be very, very happy when I tell him about this. So I really enjoyed an interview I had this morning with two people who are rapidly becoming two of my favorites here in the city for a story I'm doing, a column I'm doing. The Soto family. Carmen, who runs the Marion Theater, her husband, of course, Cesar, who also runs the business and runs the six theaters out on the Boulevard and the Bellevue Cinema, and sat down with them talking about their mission here and their journey here. And I really think we have two special people. I'll share that with you coming up in the next hour. We did talk about leadership last night a little bit in the debate, something that we talked about a lot on this show, our lack of. That was one of the questions, which, by the way, were just given to me. I wasn't really allowed to freelance anything, although I could follow up on a question or ask the candidates to go back and reconsider the question at times. So that was the rules of the game yesterday. We'll touch on some topics like new taxes, if they get new taxes, talk about the leadership, the jail being privatized, all things that are fairly significant. And as Tom said, this kooky Arizona doctor, oh my goodness, out in Phoenix, brandishing a rifle around. And just what would you do? What are you thinking when you start taking a rifle out in an airport? I mean, that's right off the bat, super dumb right there. I'll tell you what happened to that doctor. And a lot more coming your way today. So stay tuned for the program over the next less than 2 hours now. And we will also play America's favorite game, Fake or Factoid. And we're about to say goodbye to Ashley. Short timer. She only got, what, three more days, Ashley?
Not quite. I'm here till next Friday.
Oh, next Friday.
Next Friday.
You scared me. I thought you were leaving this Friday.
Nope, but I'll bring cake.
You'll bring cake? I'll buy coffee. Well, I just say this. I still think you should reconsider. Instead of going down and becoming a space engineer, you know, I think you should stay and do radio. It's much more lucrative. You know that, of course. So we're going to work on you between now and then and talk you out of it. So UCF, right?
Yes, UCF.
And what's the program called?
Aerospace Engineering.
Aerospace Engineering. Well, there you go. You'll be shipping rockets. Of course, you'll like today's Faker Facto. It's a lot about people walking on the moon. So you'll like that part of it.
Did you hear what she said, though? I said, well, would you come back to Ocala when you graduate? A resounding no. There's no job opportunities for me here.
Now.
Well, I told her Lockheed Martin's here. They're aerospace engineering.
Right. Now, we'll see. You know what? And what we want for her is to go where the best opportunity is.
That's Ocala.
So there you go. We got our mind made up for us. Okay, Ashley. Well, we'll just make the most of it while you're here. All right?
Thank you so much.
Beat up on Tom and Faker Factor today.
Huh?
That'll carry that with you for long. All right. We'll take a break. We'll come back. We'll tackle those stories. We'll talk about the last night's debate. A little about the Sotos. Much more to come right here on the show called The Voice of Ocala, live from the Paddock Mall on
1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local on The Source.
Hi, it's Lisa Midget with Kinetic Motion Fitness. I'm looking forward to a fun, healthy summer, and I have a few ideas that might just help you and your friends stay in shape and have fun too. Along with awesome personal training and group classes at our warm and inviting fitness studio, we also offer fitness classes at your home or business. And if you're tired of the same old, boring cake and punch party, why not let us host a hot new health trend, a fitness party at your home or office? If you're having a hard time getting to the gym this summer, because of your crazy schedule, then work out with your friends or coworkers in a private group fitness class or host a fitness party at your home or office. We will bring you and your friends or coworkers one of our great workouts like Zumba, Piloxing, Body Bar, Yoga, Tai Chi, Boot Camp, or Zumbatomics for kids. We can even help you reach your long-term goals by meeting at your place weekly for an on-location workout. Check out our website at kmfocala.com and like us on Facebook. Kinetic Motion Fitness is located just 5 minutes from downtown Ocala near the Skylark Plaza. Kinetic Motion Fitness. We're ready when you are.
Hi, this is Lisa Midget, owner of the Properties Salon in downtown Ocala. Here in Florida, we're all about summertime fun, but along with the warm weather comes humidity, which leads to the dreaded frizzies. Are you tired of checking the weather report every morning before deciding to flat iron your hair? Sick of looking like the Lion King every day by noon? Has God just not seen fit to answer your prayers for patience and silky, frizz-free hair? Well, your troubles are over. Come to the Properties Salon for one of our hair smoothing systems, specializing in Peter Coppola and Cezanne keratin smoothing treatments. The Properties Salon can tame your unruly locks with these formaldehyde-free formulas. And with the discount code BUDDYROCKS, you will save 20%. Not fighting the frizzies? Mention the same code BUDDYROCKS to save 20% off one of our many services such as cuts, color extensions, and manis and pedis. Gentlemen, this special is not just for the ladies. We do great cuts and color for men too. Check us out at theproperties.com for more information.
Hey, it's Tom James. If you just can't get enough of Buddy Martin talking sports on the radio all week, I have the solution for you. Check out his college football column each week on southernpigskin.com. That's southernpigskin.com. Everything you ever wanted to know about college football in the South.
This is WOCA, News Talk 1370.
Yeah, Lance?
Yes, George.
I'm royalty at Devon Self Storage now on Highway 200 across from Hobby Lobby. It says right here in this letter.
George, I read that letter too, and it's Devon's loyalty rewards. Pay 3 months in advance, get 5% off. Pay 6 months in advance, get 7% off. Pay 12 months in advance and get 10% off.
See, Alice, Devon Self Storage treats me like royalty. Just call them at 873-0777.
Yes, George, yes.
Hi, Robin. You look tired.
I am. I've been running all over town.
Why? Why not drive?
I need to get this stupid document notarized.
Well, that's easy. You need personal service.
Duh. That's what I've been looking for.
You need to go see Mark at the Personal Service Center. He can notarize that for you, make copies, fax it wherever, or send it out in the mail. Heck, he can even scan it and email it for you.
Really? Where is he at?
2375 Northeast 25th Avenue, on the corner of Northeast 25th Avenue and 24th Street. You can call him at 789-6683.
Personal Service Center. Thanks, Larry.
Hi,
Tammy Vett, and I'm here to tell you a few things about ABC Frederick's Appliance. They sell not only new, but used guaranteed appliances. When you call ABC Frederick's Appliance, they will provide service on what they sell and any appliances that you own. ABC Frederick's Appliance is located in Bellevue, right over the railroad tracks. Call 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. ABC Frederick's Appliance.
News Talk 1370. WOCA invites you to discover your full business potential. News Talk Radio is the perfect environment for your advertising. WOCA's News Talk format pinpoints information hungry, better educated, high income adults. So use us to talk to them. Call 732-8000. 732-8000. We're Ocala News Talk Radio. News Talk 1370. WOCA.
This is Tom Schmitz live in WOCA News Center with this news break brought to you by Gateway Bank. The LPGA Tour, the world's preeminent women's golf circuit, will open its 2015 season at Golden Ocala Golf and Equestrian Club, as announced here yesterday. The deal was confirmed early Monday by Golden Ocala General Manager Joe Donnelly, as well as Randall Coates, Chief Operating Officer of the title sponsor, Coates Golf. The tournament, which Coates said will be titled the Coates Golf Championship, presented by R&L Carriers, will begin January 28th and conclude on January 31st, the day before the Super Bowl. But it was Coates and his wife Molly, the president of Coates Golf, who spearheaded the effort to land the tournament in Ocala. As Golden Ocala members and avid golf fans, the couple viewed it not only as a local coup, but a tremendous opportunity to jumpstart and promote their golf brand. This news break was brought to you by Gateway Bank, your new old-fashioned bank. Join Buddy Fridays for Community Gazette Day at Gateway Bank.
Shot through the heart, and you're to blame, darling. You give love a bad name.
That's one of the good Bon Jovi song every now and then, right? Tom, listen up to me for a second.
Buddy, I'm all ears.
Who said we're not in the food business, we're in the people business?
Who said we're not?
Right, just think about that for a minute, okay? Just let that sit for a second. I'll come back to you. All right, here's some news for you. We like food, right?
We do.
Like Subway?
I'm a big fan of Subway.
I had it for lunch today.
Pretty good place.
Brand new Subway coming to Ocala.
Really?
Yep, new Subway coming to Ocala. It's going to be located in the Maricamp Road on the Publix Mall there. So that'll be done, I think, in the next couple of months. There's a story about that, I think, in the paper on Ocala.com. But I heard about it from my friend Julie. Told me that today. So now, here's the big one for you. How happy would you be if I said to you your favorite restaurant is coming here?
If a mellow mushroom comes here, I'm in good shape.
No, not your favorite one.
Oh, my favorite one?
Yeah.
A Waffle House?
Yeah.
I love Waffle House. There's one on 40.
Yeah, there's another one coming, though.
Stop it.
Another one coming, too. It's going to be at the I-75 and 40 Exchange, another Waffle House. One's not enough for you.
Are they going to tear the one down on 40?
No, that's what it says right here. It says on 34th Street. It says just east of Interstate 75 on West Silver Springs Boulevard. Restaurant is scheduled to open in early fall, according to Kelly Thrasher. The location is at 22nd 34th Street across from 34th Avenue, west from Zaxby's and near the avenue's intersection with West Silver Springs Boulevard. So what's that favorite thing you like to have with pecans on it?
No, I don't eat things with pecans.
What do you eat? What's your favorite thing?
My favorite thing is I like a ham, mushroom, and cheese omelet with ham, mushrooms.
No, something else you like too, yours. Chicken and waffles. You don't even
chicken and waffles.
See, you didn't bring that up at all.
Well, they don't make chicken and waffles at Waffle House.
Where they make them?
At Chicken and Waffles.
I thought they made it at Waffle House.
A restaurant in Georgia called Chicken and Waffles.
I thought I read where Bubba guy had chicken and waffles at the Waffle House.
You can order chicken and waffles.
That's what I'm saying.
But it's a la carte. They don't have it on the menu, chicken and waffles.
We're being kind of picky units. So you can get chicken and
waffles.
You can
order two chicken breasts and some waffles
Waffle House. I'd make your day. I'd give you a couple of factoids on.
But I love Waffle House. I ate at Waffle House this weekend. It was my birthday weekend. I ate at Waffle House.
Of course you did. Of course, every birthday you probably eat.
I do. Every birthday I eat at Waffle House.
Did you know if you laid all the Smithfield bacon that Waffle House serves in a year end to end, it would wrap all the way around the equator? Did you know that, Tom?
I'm pretty good, but I'm glad with that.
Yeah, it's 25,000 miles of bacon belt.
Never eat the bacon at Waffle House.
If you could stack all, you're kind of a picky eater.
I've eaten the same thing at Waffle House for the last 25 years.
Must be getting a little tired of it.
Nope, yeah. Never.
Oh, you mean every day?
I don't do it every day. I do it about once a month.
Okay. All right, so you realize that if you stack all the sausage patties that Waffle House serves in one day on top of each other, it would be nearly twice the size of the world's tallest building?
I'm okay with that.
Yeah, there you go. And if you poured all the cups of coffee Waffle House serves in a year, it'd be enough to fill 8 Olympic swimming pools.
I'm okay with that.
A few factoids for your favorite restaurant.
It is my favorite restaurant.
I'm trying to make your day for you.
I love Waffle House.
I'm trying to make your day for you.
If you don't like Waffle House, that's a you problem, not a me problem.
Probably un-American. You know how it started?
It's definitely un-Georgian.
You know how it started?
What, Waffle House?
Yeah.
Somewhere in Georgia, probably.
Avondale States.
I know exactly where it is.
They came from the Toddle House. Remember the Toddle House?
I do remember the Toddle House.
People who were actually involved working for the Toddle House, the brothers, and they started this place, and they started out with one, and boom, there you went. So that's how the Waffle House started. So they've 1961 left Toddle House to work full time at Waffle House, and Tom went full-time soon after that, and they saw the emergence of the restaurant chains focused on customer service with a short-order concept. True to his family belief, shared the ownership generously with management.
It's the only true diner-type restaurant left.
I do remember the Huddle House, too. You remember the Huddle House?
Yeah, they got Huddle Houses.
Yeah.
It's not around. As good as Waffle House.
Not many of them around.
Not many of them left. There's still some in Georgia, a lot in South Florida.
Yeah. I had a friend of mine in college, and I lived with him briefly when I was working in Jacksonville, who started something called the Village Oven.
Yep.
It was a diner, and he had about 5 of them, and then one day they just all went away. I don't know what happened.
Well, that's like the Clock restaurants. There was a bunch
of them.
They're
still around, aren't they?
Well, the one in Gainesville is still around, but they had like 7 of them in Jacksonville. They all closed.
Well, I've eaten in other different places and different Clock restaurants.
I like the Clock restaurant.
St. Pete used to have one. Yeah. If they still do or not. Yeah. Anyway, just a little restaurant news. So I go by the Marion Theater today. And I sit down with...
I wish I'd have known that. I needed some movie tickets. Pick up some movie tickets.
I'm not your courier, Tom.
I'd have done it for you.
Well, if you'd have called me while I was there, I would have got them.
I know. Carmen would have gave them to you, no problem. Great people to serve.
I just got to talk to you about this situation. This just confirmed 100 times over what I knew in my heart was true. Sat down with them, started talking about where they came. You know, they've been here a little over a year, I guess, a year and a half. And Cesar, he's Cuban. And Carmen's Peruvian.
Right.
They tell a cute story about meeting in Miami. And
which means they get good cigars and great coffee.
Yeah. Great story they tell about how they met through the grandmother or something in down in South Florida. And their first date was the Orange Bowl Parade, chaperoned.
Of course.
And all about that. And now they're smart business people. And Carmen became a banker. And actually... Cesar went to night school and became an accountant and wound up working with a guy in the theaters and got his interest in that. So anyway, I won't go into the whole story, but here's the deal. Once we got into what I wanted to talk about, which is what do they want the Marion Theater to be? And of course, they had a big show Saturday night. You hear about this?
Yeah, the After Midnight. The
Burlesque
midnight.
Review.
Yeah. Uh-huh, yeah.
How many people they had?
I heard it was over 200.
No, they turned away over 200.
Oh, is that what it was? I knew they. I heard. I thought it was over 200, but turned away over 200.
200, yeah.
Wow.
Mostly people 30 and under.
Well, of course.
Yeah, midnight
still,
show.
They got the same color money we got.
Yeah, but it's good that people see nothing to do for people. Well, there's that they do, apparently. I didn't know, at midnight. But anyway, there was a big show, and it went well, but that's not the story. The story is that we're not talking about some corporation in Minneapolis running this movie theater.
No, we're talking about two nice people who live here in our community.
Lock, stock, and barrel to our community to live.
Right.
And they have the 6 theaters out on the 40. What's it called? I forgot.
The Ocala 6. Ocala right 6, there. Right there.
On Staples.
And just before you get in the Staples Plaza, just before you get to Wing House.
And that's doing well. And they have the Bellevue. So
the Bellevue Twin.
And they told me about how they struck upon the Bellevue Theater, and that started first and so on. Anyway, the point is, as we're progressing this conversation, I'm talking to them about Cesar's an entrepreneur. He likes to kind of move around. He's gone from Coral Gables to Palm Beach to whatever. He just keeps opening theaters. And he gives one up and goes to the next one. Been successful at it. Carmen is a little bit different. Carmen came to the Marion Theater and fell flat in love with the Marion Theater. She is so emotional about that Marion Theater.
It is like her child.
It is very much like her child, literally. If you don't believe it.
No, I know.
She should have been sitting with me in the interview. We started talking about the Marion and the beautiful architecture and how wonderful it was, how she wants so badly to have this for Ocala, and she feels so privileged to have the opportunity. And tears welling up in her eyes as she's talking about this thing. I mean, really genuinely cares about this. I mean, if you don't get that someone is coming. She gave up her grandchildren in South Florida, her family moved up here, lock, stock, and barrel, and she's the driving force of Marion Theater. I just want to say, on the record, I love Carmen Soto. All right, I love Cesar too.
One of the nicest people you ever meet. Both of them are very nice.
This town is so lucky to have the Sotos, and especially someone who loves that place like she does. So I want to get that out there today.
Did you find out though in your interview? Are they going to have the Get On Up movie? The James Brown movie, is it going to be there?
I didn't really get into movies, Tom. It was more about the personal story.
The James Brown movie is going to be there.
That's good.
After having the Four Seasons movie there?
Yeah.
Wow.
That, by the way, that Jersey Boys went quite well.
Jersey Boys was a good movie.
It went well there at the theater.
Great.
Some movies do better. Some don't. Terminators, they couldn't do. They just couldn't make it work there.
But the Jersey Boys.
Perfect movie for that theater.
You know why? There's something that this guy, Buddy Martin, keeps telling me we're going to include on the show here, and I've heard rumors that there's something in the works to have somebody on to do this regularly. Mm-hmm. The nostalgia of it all.
Why would we want to do a show like that?
Just saying, this guy, Buddy Martin, thinks that nostalgia is a good idea.
And you and your friends say, oh, geez, those old people, they're at it again. Oh, my gosh. So
a guy with as much paper as I got with history on it, nostalgia is not something I'm going to shy away from.
Anyway, I just want to share that with them about that. Okay, I want to tell you about this after the break, but last night I went down to the debate.
Wait, who said that about food? We don't sell food, we sell what quote was that?
That was the owners of the Waffle House.
What was the quote again?
We are not in the food business, we're in the people business. Joe Rogers, co-founder of Waffle House.
Wow, pretty good statement. I thought Mark Twain maybe.
Yeah, I didn't make it in quotes today, but I got some good ones. Anyway, we'll set this up now. You know, I hadn't been to a political debate here. I've been to them before, and I didn't know quite what to expect last night because we had a format. Everything was set up in a certain way, and it wasn't a true debate like you couldn't just fire away at each other. There were formats. You get 4 minutes, you get a minute and a half response, and you get a 30-second response. So it's built in, so there's not a lot of confrontational situations there. But in essence, it really wasn't a true debate.
Right. It was a discussion.
It was a discussion, and it was got a little spicy in places. I'll tell you about what you want in your candidates. You know, Glenn Fiorella, former county commissioner, and of course the incumbent Carl Zeller. We talked about, as I said, the subjects we touched upon included things like, you know, raising property taxes, pay for things. What are you going to do? Where do you get the money from to fix the infrastructure? We talked about should the jail be privatized. We talked about three or four of the hot topics, Silver Springs, and I'll share some of that with you. But anyway, kudos to the League of Women Voters for doing this, because let's face it, we know how it is that, be honest, most people don't pay attention. They just don't pay attention. We kind of do because it's our job, but we found out that most people don't pay attention. So that's why we keep bringing this stuff up. That's why the League of Women Voters is so important, to make sure that you do have the opportunity to learn, and if you want to listen. And so last night's debate was pretty good. There's going to be some more. I'll do one with the school board later on. So anyway, I'll tell you about that debate. We'll tell you about the guy at the Phoenix Airport. Lots more to come your way here on a Tuesday on the Voice of Ocala.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local on the source. What happiness means to you? Because I'm the happy life alone. If you feel like that's what you want to do. Bring me down.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And so is State Farm agent Angie Lewis, working hard to serve her community as a citizen and insurance agent. Angie wants to help you as you adjust your insurance needs to your life, from everything to helping educate your teen driver to protecting your family against everyday risk. She wants to change the way you perceive insurance by developing relationships with her clients, which is why Angie and her staff are proud to be a part of so many good causes in Ocala. In turn, she has chosen to single out those who step up as leaders. Each month on The Voice of Ocala, Angie spotlights a good neighbor, saluting those who give exceptional service or do random acts of kindness to others. For this, Angie was written up in State Farm's National Magazine. Angie also supports local businesses with a regular Biz Buzz. The Angie Lewis State Farm Agency is located at 1122 Northeast 36th Avenue, where visitors are always welcome and the coffee pot is always on.
Hey, Eddie, I'm playing Augusta in a few hours, and I need a fourth. Want to join us?
Georgia's close, but it's not that close, Alex.
Not Georgia. Golden Ocala. I'm a member at Golden Ocala, and this course has 8 tribute holes, like number 12 and 13. You know, part of Amen Corner and the postage stamp and the road hole. It's a phenomenal track. My family and I always have a great time at the pool and at the restaurants. They've got 3, you know. The kids love the tennis programs. My wife practically lives at the spa, and I've been bulking up with a personal trainer in their fitness center. Joining Golden Ocala was one of the best decisions I've ever made, aside from marrying my wife, of course. So you want to join us in a few hours?
Absolutely. I can't wait to play the first hole in golf and the road hole too. Hey, how do I become a member at Golden Ocala?
Eddie, just call 352-402-4343.
Luxury and great golf is affordable at Golden Ocala. Call 352-402-4343 to join.
Fox News Radio, I'm Karen McHugh. President Obama has announced new penalties by the U.S. and the EU on Russia targeting their energy and financial sectors.
The sanctions we're announcing today will have an even bigger bite.
The increased sanctions are in response to the downing of Malaysia Flight 17 over Ukraine. Israeli tanks have knocked out Gaza's one and only power plant that could leave the region without lights for weeks. The State Department urges both sides to avoid hitting civilian targets.
We certainly urge all parties to respect the civilian nature of schools and medical facilities. These facilities, which serve as shelters.
Spokeswoman Jen Psaki, the body of a teenage stowaway was found inside the wheel well of an Air Force plane in Germany. The Pentagon isn't yet sure where he came from.
The deceased was an adolescent black male, possibly of African origin. The aircraft had just returned from supporting Africa Command operations with stops in a few countries.
Spokesman Admiral John Kirby, Fox News. We report, you decide.
I'm Lex Friedman. I run my own business, so I know from experience, hiring new employees can be tough. Posting your job in one place isn't enough to find quality candidates. If you want to find the perfect hire, you need to post your job on all the top job sites, and now you can. With ZipRecruiter.com, you can post your job to 50-plus job sites, including Craigslist, LinkedIn, and Twitter, all with a single click. Find candidates in any industry nationwide. Just post once and watch your qualified candidates roll in to ZipRecruiter's easy-to-use interface. No juggling emails or calls to your office. Quickly screen candidates, rate them, and hire the right person fast. Find out today why ZipRecruiter has been used by over 200,000 businesses. And right now, our listeners can post jobs on ZipRecruiter for free by going to ZipRecruiter.com/info. That's ZipRecruiter.com/info. One more time, to try it for free, go to ZipRecruiter.com/info.
Each morning, we wake up thankful to live in a free nation with liberty and justice for all. But sometimes those liberties can be put in jeopardy, and you may have questions about what to do or who to call. Let Doc Blanchard of Blanchard, Miriam, Adele, and Kirkland help you find the answers. Attorneys at law since 1974 and located in downtown Ocala. If you have legal issues, don't go it alone. Call 352-732-7218. Blanchard, Miriam, Adele, and Kirkland, helping protect your liberties every day.
On the next AM Ocala Live, Robin and I will be speaking to Dr. Clifford W. Bassett. He's coming up to speak to us about how to travel safely with allergies.
News Bites, the hottest news and current events are bite-sized.
And then Paul Fredrickson is coming on. He helped develop the brand names you know, like Home Depot, Dixie, Crystal Sugar, RCA, GE Consumer Electronics, and he's coming on our show to teach us how to successfully brand our own businesses.
Leroy Fleming is a poet and an inspirational speaker. He's written a book called Soul Splitting, a journey where mind, body, body and spirit questions the heart of daily living.
And then Higher Education Happenings. Mike Fallon will be in the studio. He's the Community Relations Coordinator for Webster University. He'll be here with several guests talking about education.
Have all of your legal questions answered by Attorney John Fuller on Legally Yours.
And then Recovery Talk with Carrie Bone. She's a professional outreach representative for the Refuge in Ocala. All of that plus Fun with Joe on the next AM Ocala Live right here on the Source WOCA 96.3 FM.
1370 AM.
Hey, Matt, I know Sunrise Automotive does auto stuff, but I need some tires for my truck. Can you recommend someone?
Yes, I can. We do that.
No, I mean, I need them installed and balanced and all that.
Yep, we do that.
Well, my son needed his windows tinted.
Yep, we do that.
I need my seat replaced.
Yep, we do that too.
I need a new roofline, a new spoiler, and a new truck.
Yep, we can even do that too.
Okay, I get it. I suppose you can also do a radio show too, huh?
Well, as a matter of fact, join me every Monday at 10 for auto repair with personal care here on The Source.
Of course you do.
Kane is in the building.
Yeah! It's alright, already the show goes on all night. Till the morning we dream so long. Anybody ever wonder when they would see the thunder? Just remember when you come to the show goes on.
Back on the Voice for Ocala on a Tuesday afternoon, coming up at 5 o'clock around the water cooler. Tom James taking a powder today. I would have thought he'd have been all over this thing with his new coach, Byron Scott. But we should have Dave Pinkelor from down in Orlando to weigh in on a few things, including, I'm sure you have a Ray Rice comment. Football's here. You can't turn on the ESPN without seeing another training camp opening up. So that'll be in the topic of discussions today in sports, along with the usual stuff in the Tampa Bay Rays, still rocking. Tom told you about the LPGA story and the new tournament coming to town. We'll talk more about that. We have our go-longs. I'm going to talk about the heritage of quarterbacks at the University of Florida and the state of Florida. And Tom says something about let kids be kids, and no, it's not about this show. It does kind of sound like it, though. All right, last night at the County Commission debate, incumbent Carl Zalek and Glenn Fiorella. By the way, I started off the session by saying, first things first. Let's get this first thing out of the way. I got to have a selfie. So I shot a selfie of myself there with a commission behind me. So it's pretty cool. And then I said, let's make sure we correctly pronounce the names, Fiorella and Zalek. Now, I noticed that one person was calling him Zalek. And I've heard his name pronounced. I said, okay, so I've had you both on a radio show, and I think it's Fiorella and Zalek. Am I right? They said, right. You're right. So I got that part right. But anybody got to the discussion of taxes and—
Did anybody bring up the fact that the raging moderate was the moderator?
That would be a good thing if it was. It would be a good thing.
I'm just saying the raging moderate was a moderator. So I'm seeing irony there.
I don't see a whole lot of irony, and I see it as a plus, actually, because the guy who's in the middle should be objective.
Moderator
is someone who moderates the session. A moderate is someone who is in the middle. So just so
well,
you know.
You're in the middle of the session.
Well, that's the perfect place to be as a moderator. Yeah. Isn't anybody better than that? Who would you want?
No, they picked the best guy.
Would you like to have Glenn Beck as a moderator?
I would like to have Glenn Beck as a person sitting next to me on a plane. Are you kidding me?
All right, anyway, so you get the drift, okay? So the format was set. I won't go into all the details, but we had a pretty good civic lesson there, some information. I even learned a few things like the exact population of the county, the unemployment rate, and so on and so forth. And then we asked the questions, and sometimes candidates were given 4 minutes to respond. And the opposing candidate was given a minute and a half to respond to that. And then at the end, they're allowed to ask each other questions. It didn't get too feisty. Both candidates, the one thing I did ask about was leadership. That was a question in this program about the leadership. The fact there's been a lot of articles written about it in the local newspaper. They were asked what they would do about it. And I thought they both kind of hedged their bets on it. They kind of talked about what they had done or want to do and things that, and I didn't quite. I wanted to hear something about, you know, what is leadership? Who leads? You know, how do you lead? What are ways to lead? But now we got a little more about, well, I did this and I did this and I'm going to do this when I'm elected. So that was just okay. This kind of surprised me on the issue of privatizing the jail.
How would you think they'd come down on that?
I would think that Fiorella would be against it, and because Carl Zalek is part of the county commission who's looking into it, he'd be for it.
Actually, they both were against it.
Good for them.
And Zalek even said he didn't exactly throw somebody else under the bus, but he did say that that was introduced by Commissioner McClain.
so he didn't
own it.
Right, I understand.
And I'm glad they said that, because I think it's a horrible idea, in my opinion. And I think Fiorella made a good point about, well, you know, people complain about whether Palace left Silver Springs in bad condition when they leased it. How do you think the jail's going to look after 20 years, you know? That was a good point. And then the other one I thought was the most interesting was the new taxes thing. In view of the fact that we have infrastructure, we have issues, and we have things that have to be taken care of in our community, you know, other than raising real estate taxes, do you see any ways to raise revenue? And both of them, neither one of them responded in kind. And I finally asked the question of Carl Zalek, what about the 1 cent sales tax? Hello? Did we not have a conversation about the 1 cent sales tax on the show?
We've had it.
And his response was, well, it couldn't be on the ballot on the primary because it wouldn't get enough people. Felt like it wasn't fair. It needed to be on in the ballot later if that's what the people want. And then Fiorella shot back, well, yeah, it should have been on the ballot. The people should have been able to decide the 1 cent sales tax. And when I asked Alec a follow-up question, is it going to happen? He says, I don't know. So they're kicking that can down the road is what they're doing on that.
Well,
so
that of course, was probably because they're trying to run away from the fact that they were, you know, dictators.
Right. Now, I don't want to say come down hard on one candidate or the other. I'm not, because I feel like as a position of a moderator, I don't want to compromise that, because I was just there as a person to elicit comments. But so I'm not going to give either one of them a grade or anything else. I'm just telling you what was said. I don't know what are the questions. Now, I didn't ask these questions. They were all pre-programmed. People were asked what they wanted to ask them. This is the questions that were brought and written out. So is there anything else that you would have asked had you been there? Silver Springs was asked, talked about some of
them. Let me ask this one question.
Yeah.
After moderating this last night,
yeah,
without saying whether somebody's name, do you feel both candidates are worthy of the position of county commissioner? No matter which one wins, are they both worthy of the job?
I think they're worthy candidates.
Yeah,
are they the best candidates? I don't know.
But are they worthy of being candidates?
I think they're worthy candidates.
Right.
And depending on who else is out there, I don't know, about our way of put up against somebody else. I would like to see, and I don't want to go too deep into this, and Glenn has already been a commissioner.
Right.
As well.
Carl is a
commissioner, so they've already been commissioners. That bodes well for them in a way. On the other hand, you don't want professional politicians to be your county commissioners. And their salaries, by the way, with benefits, $103,000.
And I found out that they get, once they get to 8 years.
Retirement.
Yeah, and it's crazy what they get, 3% a year.
It's a good deal.
3% a year, so after 8 years, they get 24% of their ending salary.
Yeah, but the bottom line is, I think they're both good men. I don't know if they're the best people, but on the other hand, I don't know anybody else to put in their place. Do you? It's kind of like Will Muschamp. I think Will Muschamp is a good coach. He's not doing very well, and I don't know who else to put in his
yeah,
place.
Yeah, like they. Well, if you fire him, who are you going to put?
Yeah,
there?
So I don't know. I mean, so I'm not making. I'm just saying.
I know a guy, but he's not ready to run yet. But
you?
I know a guy.
You?
No, no.
Oh, okay.
No. But I know a guy.
Well,
pretty good golfer. This guy.
The problem is
the problem is that
not would he? That's the other thing.
Right.
Would he run?
Yeah.
A lot of people wouldn't run.
I know a guy that's a pretty good golfer that I think would be a pretty good county commissioner.
Yeah, we'll see. I think he's got a job, doesn't he?
He does have a job.
Yeah. So that's all right. So that's the deal.
Got a son that's a pretty good golfer too.
Yeah. All right. Arizona doctor story. He's arrested on suspicion of pointing a rifle. Now, get this. He's got a rifle in the Phoenix airport.
Which is perfectly legal.
Yeah, I know. Which is scary by itself. He points it toward a woman and her 17-year-old daughter in the airport. Nathan Steinmetz. He's not 18 or 20. He's 54. Removed the AR-15-style rifle from a hanging position over his shoulder inside Phoenix Sky Harbor International in the busiest terminal on Friday and pointed it in the direction of the women.
Right. He laid it across his arms and it was pointed at the women and made the women feel uncomfortable. It wasn't like he sighted them in, but he did have the barrel of the gun pointed at these two women like an idiot.
They felt threatened. So no shots were fired. Unclear if the rifle was loaded. I hope it wouldn't be loaded, for crying out loud.
Perfectly legal in Arizona.
And he was arrested shortly thereafter, suspicion of two felony counts of disorderly conduct. Police interviewed two women, said they indicated they were in fear for their safety, reportedly. No information whether he knew the women. Steinbass told police he was at the airport to get coffee and had no other business there.
Yep, that's it.
That's great.
Take
your rifle down to the airport, get a cup
of coffee. Well, he was making an open carry stand. He was showing that you could open carry in certain places in Arizona and that it's legal and people need to get over themselves freaking out when they see guns. I know what he was trying to do.
Sure.
But stop it. You know, it's kind of like the old attitude you got. What did your mom used to tell you as a kid? Learn to pick your battles. Taking a loaded gun or an unloaded rifle, either one, into an airport to prove that you can do it probably ain't the battle you need to pick.
I can tell you there are no open carries where he's going.
No. Well, there may be by the guards on the yard.
Yeah. Apparently, this guy is that's not some rummy. The St. Joseph Hospital Medical Center says Stamos is the director of the neuroengineering program. So there you go.
Wait, so he's a brain doctor?
A brain doctor. Really? Yeah, it's funny, isn't it? Yeah.
That really makes it a great story there.
Yeah, really.
So a brain doctor who didn't use his brain.
I think it must be brain dead.
So. Brain dead.
Yeah. All right, we're going to get to this story, hopefully, about the women getting smarter than men are, but take a break, come back, and we'll play Fake or Facto and tell you the story about the findings of older people from 13 different countries about whether women are getting smarter faster than men. Coming up next on the Voice of Ocala.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
Regions Bank has big bank ability but possesses small bank agility. Utilizing tools like Raymond Andrews and his team of six mortgage experts with 100 years of experience in the mortgage industry and 50 years experience as members of the Regions Bank team. Mortgage lending is personal and important, and you deserve someone that will lead you through a positive process. Raymond and his team use local mortgaging processes like local appraisers and local closing to help you have a positive experience, and they habla Espanol as well. So whether you need a conventional, FHA, USDA, or VA loan, or you even need a construction loan, the mortgage team of your local Regions Bank has the knowledge and experience to guide you through the process. So contact Raymond Andrews and his team of mortgage experts at 352-854-4104. That's 352-854-4104. Regions Bank, it's time to expect more.
Right on the southwestern corner of the square sits one of the finest dining establishments in Florida, Mark's Prime Steakhouse and Seafood Restaurant. Mark's offers big city dining amenities in a charming and small town setting. It's a rare treat to experience both the ambiance and the exquisite cuisine in a friendly atmosphere. Ocala's finest restaurant serves the finest beef, the freshest seafood, premium wines, and naturally fresh vegetables. From valet parking to splendid service, Mark's offers the complete package. Check it out today. Mark's Prime Seafood and Steakhouse Restaurant.
Hi, I'm Tom Ingram, CEO of Gateway Bank, inviting you to drop by our main office on Silver Springs Boulevard every Friday from 3 to 6 p.m. for the Community Gazette, a three-hour show focusing on our favorite community to live and work, Ocala, Marion County. Come join us with the voice of Ocala, Buddy Martin, in the new old-fashioned bank radio studio as we discuss a variety of interesting topics on the Community Gazette on WOCA, The Source.
Your home is safe. Or is it? AA Lock, Dock, and Security. The name has been a staple in Ocala since 1985. Do you have the right equipment in place to have peace of mind when you are at home or away? AA Lock, Dock, and Security has the right people to install and monitor your home or business. Call today for a free on-site security analysis. Call 867-1965. AA Lock, Dock, and Security, 219 Northwest 10th Street, 867-1965.
Veterans are the foundation upon which our freedom is built. Listen to The Source, WOCA, each Thursday at 9 a.m. to Veterans News with Hank Whittier from Vets Helping Vets. You'll hear tributes, information on veterans' issues, and stories that will make you laugh, cry, and feel proud. Veterans News always focuses on the military, past and present, and on our first responders. Veterans News is brought to you each week by Palm Chevrolet, where supporting the community is the Palm Chevy way, and by Bob Wine's Camellia Gardens and Nursery, keeping you blooming since 1952.
Here's what you may have missed on the John Tesh Radio Show.
On which day are we most likely to have a tension headache? If you guess Monday, well, you're right on. If you want to get noticed, just smile more often. People, it turns out, spot others whose teeth are showing when they smile twice as fast as those who have closed mouths. And they don't want to go where you want to go. They don't want to do what you like to do. If that sounds familiar, focus on your other friends.
Intelligence for your life on the John Tesh Radio Show. Don't miss this stuff.
The weather is brought to you by MyFWC.com. Safe boating is no accident. A mix of sun and clouds today with a couple of showers and a thunderstorm later on today. High 89 to 92. There'll be a shower or thunderstorm around this evening otherwise. Partly cloudy skies tonight. Low 73 to 77. And tomorrow we have times of sun and clouds with a couple of showers and a thunderstorm. High 91 to 93. From the Florida Weather Center, I'm Stephanie Omo.
All right, I'm going to do this story for Faker or Factoid today. Tom playing against Ashley. Ashley feels like she has the upper hand today. I got the Vegas line, and she's a 3-1 favorite over Tom today. I don't know why.
She has no shot.
So, meanwhile, there's this story about brains and about women and getting faster, smarter, faster than men, which is a little scary maybe the fact that they're already ahead of us. But the story today moved on Yahoo, I probably won't have time to get into it here because I'm having trouble putting it up. But essentially, the science shows that women, for whatever reason, are getting smarter faster than men.
Because they are smarter than men.
That's true. That's true. And that tells you, because we're so preoccupied with ourselves, we don't have a chance to, you know, we don't really open ourselves up to new information and don't listen. That would be part of the reason. So,
what'd you say?
Yeah. That's exactly what I'm talking about right there. Well, all right, so put on music, play a little Faker or Factoid here today on a Monday.
Or the destruction of Ashley, depending on how you want to call it.
Excuse you, I think we just said women are smarter than men.
There you go.
Ooh, look at there, look at there.
There you go. And not only that, getting smarter faster.
She's firing back,
buddy. As you notice by her comments, so she's getting smarter faster. All right, here we go. America's favorite new game. Fake or Factoid? By the way, goodbye to Katie Couric. She's going off the air tomorrow. Number one, the idea for Captain America actually came from a Chinese book. Fake or Factoid? Please take turns.
Fake.
Fake.
Both say fake. Anybody want to change their answer? Nobody does, and you're correct. It's fake.
Yeah.
This could be a day where I might have all five fake. You never know.
Well, but on the other hand,
never. Number two, the Hawaiian alphabet has 12 letters. Fake or factoid?
Fake.
That is, in fact, a fact.
Fact of fact. Not just a fact, but a fact of fact.
In fact, that is a fact.
Tom says fact. Ashley says fake. And Tom is correct. It is a fact. 12 letters.
I'm well aware of that.
Yes, we know, Tom. You got it correct. Number three, on December 1972, U.S. astronaut Eugene Cernan became the last person to set foot on the moon.
Fact.
Fact.
Both say fact?
It was Apollo 17.
Smarty pants. She's just trying to show you she's smarter. Correct. You're both correct. Number four, only four others, including one Russian, came before him.
Fake.
Fake.
Now, why would you say fake?
Because there's never been a Russian on the moon.
Are you sure of that?
Positive.
You want to double down?
I'm just saying.
Huh? You want to double down?
Okay.
Huh? You're both correct. It's fake.
Never been a Russian on the moon?
That's the idea. That's why it's called fake.
Yeah.
I make them up, Tom. That's what they call fake. Number five, the name Uncle Sam for the U.S. came from a person known as Uncle Sam Wilson of Troy, New York, who supplied food for the U.S. Army. Fake or factoid? Let him go first because you have to go opposite.
That sounds dumb enough to be fact.
Fake.
Unfortunately, it's fact.
It's fact. It is fact. I just fooled you by saying that's dumb enough. I knew it was fact. Yeah. He actually supplied the meat in the War of 1812.
Now, let's see. Here's a two-part question real fast, okay?
You'll get this right, I bet.
How many men, the number, have actually walked on the moon?
May I go first?
Yes.
12.
12, she says.
11.
11, says Tom. Actually wins a number. It's 12. Can you name any of them?
She was right.
Yes, I can.
She can name them all, I guarantee you.
Name them.
Aldrin, Armstrong, Bean, Cernan, Conrad, Duke, Irwin, Mitchell, Schmidt, Shepard, Scott, and Young.
There's 12.
I told you women are smarter than men. I'm going to give her a tie on the game just for getting that.
Yeah. Well, that was right in her wheelhouse.
Of course, we fix it that way. All right, good job, Ashley. All right, coming up next, we'll talk about sports.
You're going to do a...
Give me tweets and quotes. Yes, number one, I have not failed. I just found 10,000 ways it won't work. Thomas Edison. Number two, once you eliminate the impossible, whatever remains, no matter what and how improbable, must be the truth. And finally, black holes are where God divided by zero. Stephen Wright. Coming up next, sports.
On 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, we're live and local on The Source.
Smile and Robert Redford hair. But you walked across my heart like it was Texas. And you taught me how to say.
Hello, I'm Dawn Lovell, lead event designer and owner at Party Time Rentals. Have you ever wondered what it takes to make an event spectacular? Well, look no further. It's what we do every day. Whether you're hosting an intimate dinner for 10 or a gala for thousands, at Party Time Rentals, we find just the right style and elegance to make your event a success. Our extensive inventory of the finest in chandeliers, tents, crystal, china, and specialty items is featured in our fabulous showroom. Stop by and say hello. It's a great way to get ideas for an event and experience for yourself how you can make your party time special.
Party Time Rentals, located on Southwest 10th Street, just off Route 200 in Ocala, and off Southwest 34th Street in Gainesville. For more information, call 352-629-8858. That's 352-629-8858. The party begins at Party Time.
Men, do you know your testosterone level? Are you experiencing decreased energy levels or unusual sleeping problems? Have you noticed you have less strength or endurance, decreased sex drive, increased irritability or depression? If so, you may be experiencing problems with low testosterone. If you're interested in a free testosterone screening, please call RenStar Medical Research at 352-629-5800. Again, that number is 352-629-5800.
Hi, I'm Tom Ingram, CEO of Gateway Bank, the new old-fashioned bank. Let us introduce you to Okus, a simple way to bring your business online. Through this relationship, your business can have a fully functioning website in less than 30 minutes. We will also provide you support with social media, sales tracking, e-commerce, and online scheduling, which is all optimized for mobile users. Okus, now at Gateway Bank, Silver Springs Boulevard, Ocala. Come visit our technology center for your total small business solution. I'm Tom Ingram, and I'll see you there.
Hey, it's Tom James. If you just can't get enough of Buddy Martin talking sports on the radio all week, I have the solution for you. Check out his college football column each week on SouthernPigskin.com. That's SouthernPigskin.com. Everything you ever wanted to know about college football in the South.
Hello. Can you hear me? Because if you can, then so can your customers. Radio works. Call today to advertise your business right here on WOCA 1370, The Source.
Now is the time to take advantage of Florida Credit Union's CD specials. Our 36-month CD comes in at 1.26% APY. A 24-month is working for you at 1.0% APY. And our 12-month at 0.75% APY. All CD rate specials require $10,000 minimum. With friendly service and rates like these, it's not hard to see why Florida Credit Union has your CD options covered. Florida Credit Union, connecting your money to your life. Call 352-237-8222 for more information. Must act by 1/15/14.
Good credits, bad credits. It's none of our business because we're not an auto dealer. We're not a bank. We're not your mother. We're OcalaForSale.com, Marion County's marketplace for cars, trucks, and SUVs. We've got thousands of sellers standing by to take your call. No middleman. But hurry, don't walk, don't run. Just sit down and log on to OcalaForSale.com.
Prices and inventory change daily. Offered is not include dealer upcharge. Undercutting, rust proofing, factory surcharge, or delivery fee. See website for details.
How good does it get?
Golf has long been considered to be sport's most prestigious game, and WOCA has your connection to everything in the golf world. Every first and third Thursday at 10 a.m., tune in for Let's Talk Golf with your host, PGA professional and teacher to the stars, Jim Beckett, and operations manager for the Links of Spruce Creek South, Darren Irwin, right here on The Source.
I'm Yvette, and I'm here to tell you a few things about ABC Frederick's Appliance. They sell not only new, but used guaranteed appliances. When you call ABC Frederick's Appliance, they will provide service on what they sell and any appliances that you own. ABC Frederick's Appliance is located in Bellevue, right over the railroad tracks. Call 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. ABC Frederick's Appliance.
Here's what you may have missed on the John Tesh Radio Show.
On which day are we most likely to have a tension headache? If you guess Monday, well, you're right on. If you want to get noticed, just smile more often. People, it turns out, spot others whose teeth are showing when they smile twice as fast as those who have closed mouths. And they don't want to go where you want to go. They don't want to do what you like to do. If that sounds familiar, focus on your other friends.
Intelligence for your life on the John Tesh Radio Show. Don't miss this stuff.
Broadcasting from the Paddock Mall Studios, this is WOCA, Ocala, Gainesville, The Villages, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source.
Fox News Radio, I'm Karen McHugh. The president hits Russia with more sanctions.
Today, and building on the measures we announced 2 weeks ago, the United States is imposing new sanctions in key sectors of the Russian economy. Energy, arms, and finance.
The U.S. joins with the EU. The sanctions are in response to the shootdown of Malaysia Flight 17. An American in West Africa has died from the Ebola virus.
Two other American aid workers remain in isolation after contracting Ebola in Liberia. One of them, Dr. Grant Brantley, remains in grave condition. The other, Nancy Reitbol, is said to be stable.
Fox's Paul Tilsey on Capitol Hill.
On this vote, the yeas are 97, nays are zero. Confirmation is confirmed.
The Senate confirms former P&G CEO Robert McDonald is the new head of the Department of Veterans Affairs. The 61-year-old McDonald takes over the troubled agency following the resignation of Eric Shinseki. Fox News. We report, you decide.
I'm Lex Friedman. I run my own business, so I know from experience, hiring new employees can be tough. Posting your job in one place isn't enough to find quality candidates. If you want to find the perfect hire, you need to post your job on all the top job sites, and now you can. With ZipRecruiter.com, you can post your job to 50-plus job sites, including Craigslist, LinkedIn, and Twitter, all with a single click. Find candidates in any industry nationwide. Just post once and watch your qualified candidates roll in to ZipRecruiter's easy-to-use interface. No juggling emails or calls to your office. Quickly screen candidates, rate them, and hire the right person fast. Find out today why ZipRecruiter has been used by over 200,000 businesses. And right now, our listeners can post jobs on ZipRecruiter for free by going to ZipRecruiter.com/info. That's ZipRecruiter.com/info. One more time. To try it for free, go to ZipRecruiter.com.
How much time? 30? 30 seconds. I'm on right now. I don't believe you.
Okay, okay. Enough kidding around.
Ho, 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 ho. Ho, ho, ho.
And now it's time for the
Buddy Martin Sports Page.
He actually had me stay here last night in his gym.
It's like I don't belong here.
Let's go talk to a couple of guys that never gamble.
Oh, see, I made Lewis a bet here. See, Lewis bet me that we couldn't both get rich and put you on the poorhouse at the same time. He didn't think we could do it.
Gambling is illegal at Bushwood, sir, and I never slice.
And now,
here's Buddy.
It's time for the program known as Buddy Sports Page right here on the Voice of Ocala, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA. And today we go around the water cooler. We've got some news. We got some commentaries. We'll have tell you about the Stampede. You know, the local soccer team doing pretty good right now.
One beat Austin, won the division.
Yeah, I'm going to tell you about that. Tom, we're going to elaborate more on why this whole thing with the LPGA starting their season in Ocala next year is significant, because it's not just an event. It's what we hope will be more events, like we've got the State Junior College Tournament here now, right? We got the LPGA event here. We're keep building on these things that we can do so well in our community, and what better place to play this event but Golden Ocala. Tom will tell you about that. We'll talk about RL Carriers making that happen. And how about my Rays? They got knocked off by Big Poppy and the Red Sox the other night, ended their streak at 9. But they're right back up again and got good pitching again last night. They knocked off Milwaukee. The Rays are making a run here, and I hope they make a run enough to keep David Price. So we'll talk about that. Tom James should have been here today because there's news about his Los Angeles Lakers. He won't be able to crow until next Tuesday. And if I go along, I'll talk about the rich heritage of Gator quarterbacks after my visit out to the Brantley quarterback camp this past weekend. Tom will talk about let kids be kids or sportscasters be sportscasters. I don't know. Same thing. Meanwhile, Tom has some headlines for you today.
Yeah, buddy. John Abrahams, the Arizona Cardinals Pro Bowl linebacker, who is no longer an Atlanta Falcon linebacker, thank goodness, arrested around 4 p.m. in June. It had to be today. It couldn't have been June 29th.
It happened today, I think.
Had to happen today. This just has to be a misprint, June 29th. After he had left the Pink Pony Strip Club, according to police reports, he was passed out behind the wheel of his Dodge Black Challenger. More details about Abraham's arrest on DUI charges in suburban Atlanta suburb emerged Tuesday, including what it took officers several minutes to wake Abraham up. No, I guess this was on the 29th. This is court records and all coming out.
Okay.
Abraham could appear confused and ramble while speaking. He said he'd had two drinks, told officers at the scene he'd been waiting on someone to pick him up. That person never arrived. He also said he didn't feel safe to drive and didn't want to drive. He failed a series of field sobriety tests, including the walking and balancing test. Also, Abraham's couldn't recite the alphabet. Finally, he gave up. All of this led to him being arrested.
Nah, he's old news anyway now. It doesn't matter.
So, Josh Gordon, the Cleveland Browns wide receiver who was arrested for marijuana and everything, so he's appealing the NFL's imposition of a year-long suspension for a positive test. His legal team will argue the positive tests are so marginal that they show uncertainty as whether the test results were truly positive, and even if so, were the result of exposure to secondhand smoke.
Mm-hmm. Heard that before. There's two common statements by people like that. That's not my stuff, and it must have been secondhand smoke. Or number three, I didn't inhale.
Both samples coming from the same specimen test, the results should be consistent. Gordon's attorneys do not believe their client should be suspended because the results are not consistent. So, Bill Clinton didn't inhale, and now Josh Gordon got it from secondhand smoke.
There you go.
The NCAA, a big deal today, buddy. The NCAA settles its head injury lawsuit, will change its rules. According to this story on Yahoo.com, the NCAA agreed Tuesday to settle a class action head injury lawsuit by creating a $70 million fund to diagnose thousands of current and former college athletes to determine if they suffered brain trauma playing football, hockey, soccer, and other college sports.
Not a whole lot of money.
College sports governing body also agreed to implement a single return to play policy spelling out how all teams must treat players who received head blows. So critics, of course, have accused the NCAA of giving too much discretion to individual schools about when an athlete can go in, back into a game. So now there's going to be one universal rule, according to the NCAA. But $70 million doesn't sound like very much money.
Sure doesn't. The seed money, probably.
That's what it sounds like to me. Next story. Looks like Buddy Martin is right after all. The NBA and the Los Angeles Clippers are ready to move on, even if Donald Sterling wants to keep fighting. They're going to sell to Steve Ballmer for $2 million. As a judge said, that no longer appears to be a concern about him as ownership of the group, because a judge ruled in Los Angeles that Shelly Sterling, who negotiated the sale to Ballmer, was good in doing so, and that Donald Sterling could not block the sale because it does look like he was incompetent at the time, or the judge ruled that the doctor said he was incompetent, so Shelly was well within her rights to sell the Clippers.
The NBA, and I'm not going to say I told you so here, but the NBA was too confident about this. They knew they had him. They knew there was no way this was going to get out, and they knew they didn't go into this blind. And so they knew that Sterling was in the wrong, and they had the goods on him. And
yeah, his lawyer said they'll continue to fight.
Yeah, right. Good luck.
So they're not going to stop the sale of the team, and they're just going to cost Sterling more money. So, well, he's got $2 billion now he can fight with.
Just give that to the lawyers, too, while you're here.
Yeah, and finally, your beloved Tampa Bay Rays. Chris Archer, the pitcher who said that he agreed with David Price, saying that David Ortiz thought he was the show, bigger than the game.
Yep.
Well, he hadn't backed off. He's actually added more to that statement. A day after Ortiz slung his bat and leisurely trotted around the base, Archer had some more thoughts. When asked by reporters how things are 2 days after, he says, well, you know, I've been thinking about that. I'm not going to compare these two, but they're obviously the same class of players as far as what they've accomplished, and you never saw Hank Aaron flip a bat.
Ouch.
So, Archer... reiterate.
Going back to the archives, a little Hank Aaron on him.
I guess different people have different ways of reacting. That's just who he is. But Hammer and Hank never would have reacted that way. So, Archer, maybe
Archer.
Maybe Archer's maybe when David said he hadn't been here long enough to make those kind of comments, yeah. Archer said, I'll show you a comment.
He's got some stones.
Yeah. And you know what? He's right. Hank Aaron never flipped a bat like that.
He did not. Now, here's the other part of this. The winner in this whole thing was Big Poppy.
Oh, yeah.
Because he did exactly what he was trying to do, get in the heads of the Tampa Bay pitching staff.
Certainly.
That's his game.
And that's what he's done.
He taunted enough to do it, and now this is what they're talking about. But it will set up for some interesting games now coming up in the fall in September when they start meeting again, and there's going to be a little bit of a...
I'd put on the elbow guard if I was David Ortiz.
Yeah, sure. Well, he probably wouldn't. He just hit it with his head. He'd be all right.
Shin guard on, a little extra helmet coverage.
Just bouncing off his head, he'll be all right.
But, you know... To Archer's point, though, the greats of the game back in the day, one of your boyhood idols, Stan Musial, you ever seen him flip a bat?
Of course not. Of course, I also saw Ted Williams spit on sports writer, too, so there you go.
There you go.
Both sides of the coin on that one. I kind of like the panache of Big Poppy. I kind of like the flair. And I like the rivalry. I actually like the rivalry. Baseball needs a little something.
It's better than the Yankees Red Sox. Tired of that rivalry.
Yeah. Well, I'm not like that, but I mean, let's face it. How many good storylines are there right now in baseball? How many are there?
None.
Yeah. It's kind of a dull summer for storylines.
Speaking of, you know, the biggest storyline that nobody's talking about in baseball. They still don't have a successor for Bud Selig, and he leaves the office December 31st.
Nobody wants the job.
Nobody. I mean, you know, it's an $8.5 billion a year industry, and nobody wants the job.
Why don't they just go ahead and get Hank Aaron, and get him a right hand man, and make him commissioner?
Let him
for
be
them.
Commissioner.
Yeah.
Well, you know who I think would be a great commissioner? Really, in all
don't
honesty.
Don't say John McCain.
But he would never take the job. No, Joe Torre be a great.
He would be a great commissioner. You're right.
Great
he would be. Baseball guy, he's managed, he's played.
And he's in the front office of baseball now.
And he's impeccable. He'd be a really good idea. But, you know, I don't know if he wanted either.
He would never take the job. Would you take the job?
Well, yeah, I'd take it. Sure, you would too. But the bottom line is, it's all about litigation all the time.
Now. That's what it is now. I don't know that I would want to be, if I was coming in, because you can't rule the way Kennesaw Mountain Landis did anymore.
Of course not. You can't even rule like Bowie Kuhn did.
Right. You couldn't do like Bowie Kuhn. So I'm not real sure it's a job that, like the NBA commissioner's job was an okay job to have.
Well, yeah, but now it's all lawyers. They're right. All lawyers now.
Everybody is.
Yeah.
That's what you're going to have to have. You're going to have somebody that's a lawyer take over in baseball too.
Right.
But Joe Torre would still be a good guy to do it.
I'm enjoying the Rays. I'm going to take a look at the Marlins and see what they're doing and follow a little more baseball that's coming. And we got football upon us now, so coming up this weekend. So
I Hall like of Fame.
What's that game, by the way?
The Hall of Fame game? I'll look
check it out.
We'll I had your stat last night as I was doing trivia at Mojo's Grill and Catering Company.
Yeah.
I said, this comes from the vault of Buddy Martin with the voice of Ocala. I did a little advertisement for
good
us.
Good job.
I said, the Sunday that just passed is the last Sunday, the last weekend without football until February 8th, and the place erupted in cheers. People didn't realize it until we put it in perspective, and they really enjoyed it.
I stole it from the NFL. You keep up with the sport, MMA?
Somewhat.
A little bit. You ever heard of Joe Riggs?
Yeah, of course.
Well, he had a little problem. He's out of the fight. He's injured. He shot himself.
Yeah, he shot it. Yeah. I saw the story.
So he's scheduled a fight. Paolo Thiago, whatever his name is, and UFC fight night on and his first fight since 2006. But obviously, it's a change now. He apparently, I'm not sure how he did it, but so while cleaning his permitted firearm, a pistol, the gun discharged, injuring his hand and upper thighs. What do we say about microphones and guns, Tom?
Never an unloaded gun, never a dead microphone.
Thank you very much, sir.
But if you got a loaded gun, you could end up dead in front of a microphone.
Yes, you can. All right, that's it. Take a break, come back.
Oh, by the way, the Hall of Fame game?
Yeah.
A replay of the 1991 Super Bowl, the Whitney Houston National Anthem Super Bowl.
Giants and Bills.
Giants and Bills.
Very good. I was there to hear her sing that. The night you know who's sitting next to me? Terry Bradshaw. We sat in the stands and watched that.
Hair on the back of your neck.
Yeah, it was great. It was awesome, yeah. Speaking of Terry Bradshaw, coming up soon, it's going to be starting the Terry Bradshaw football show right here on our station. So
who we got? We got somebody important tomorrow on the radio, too.
I believe it would be the athletic director of the University of Florida, Jeremy Foley, joins us at 3:03 tomorrow. Meanwhile, Dave Pinglor is waiting for a call. So
kick off the show with Jeremy Foley.
We go. It'll be good. Take a break, come back. We'll join the Pinkster after this timeout on Buddy Sports Page.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
Hi, it's Lisa Midget with Kinetic Motion Fitness. I'm looking forward to a fun, healthy summer, and I have a few ideas that might just help you and your friends stay in shape and have fun too. Along with awesome personal training and group classes at our warm and inviting fitness studio, we also offer fitness classes at your home or business. And if you're tired of the same old, boring cake and punch party, why not let us host a hot new health trend, a fitness party at your home or office? If you're having a hard time getting to the gym this summer, because of your crazy schedule, then work out with your friends or coworkers in a private group fitness class or host a fitness party at your home or office. We will bring you and your friends or coworkers one of our great workouts like Zumba, Piloxing, Body Bar, Yoga, Tai Chi, Boot Camp, or Zumbatomics for kids. We can even help you reach your long-term goals by meeting at your place weekly for an on-location workout. Check out our website at kmfocala.com and like us on Facebook. Kinetic Motion Fitness is located just 5 minutes from downtown Ocala near the Skylark Plaza. Kinetic Motion Fitness. We're ready when you are.
Hey, it's Tom James. If you just can't get enough of Buddy Martin talking sports on the radio all week, I have the solution for you. Check out his college football column each week on southernpigskin.com. That's southernpigskin.com. Everything you ever wanted to know about college football in the South.
Hi, this is Lisa Midget, owner of the Proper Tees Salon in downtown Ocala. Here in Florida, we're all about summertime fun, but along with the warm weather comes humidity, which leads to the dreaded frizzies. Are you tired of checking the weather report every morning before deciding to flat iron your hair? Sick of looking like the Lion King every day by noon? Has God just not seen fit to answer your prayers for patience and silky, frizz-free hair? Well, your troubles are over. Come to the Proper Tees Salon for one of our hair smoothing systems, specializing in Peter Coppola and
and Saison carrot and smoothing treatments, the Proper Tea Salon can tame your unruly locks with these formaldehyde-free formulas. And with the discount code BUDDYROCKS, you will save 20%. Not fighting the frizzies? Mention the same code BUDDYROCKS to save 20% off one of our many services such as cuts, color extensions, and manis and pedis. Gentlemen, this special is not just for the ladies. We do great cuts and color for men too. Check us out at thepropertees.com for more information.
Marion County's information station, WOCA, News Talk 1370.
Coming August 8th and 9th, the first annual Ocala Bike Fest. How would you like a chance to win a 2014 Harley Street Glide? How about a 2014 Indian Chief Vintage? The tickets are only $100 each, and each chance drawing has only 599 tickets. Now that is some great odds. All proceeds go to ARC. Questions, call 387-2210. The number again is 387-2210. Ocala Bike Fest. We'll see you there.
Are you tired of not using your home's outdoor space for entertaining or relaxation because of all the bugs and leaves? Consider adding a beautiful screen room or glass enclosure. We are Superior Aluminum and Design, a family-owned and operated business with 20 years' experience in the aluminum industry, and we are accredited by the Better Business Bureau. If you appreciate superior workmanship, call Superior Aluminum and Design at 817-8058 or visit us on the web at SuperiorAluminumDesign.com.
On the next AM Ocala Live, Robin and I will be speaking to Dr. Clifford W. Bassett. He's coming up to speak to us about how to travel safely with allergies.
News Bites, the hottest news and current events are bite-sized.
And then Paul Fredrickson is coming on. He helped develop the brand names you know, like Home Depot, Dixie, Crystal Sugar, RCA, GE Consumer Electronics, and he's coming on our show to teach us how to successfully brand our own businesses.
Leroy Fleming is a poet and an inspirational speaker. He's written a book called Soul Splitting, A Journey Where Mind, Body, and Spirit Questions the Heart of Daily Living.
And then Higher Education Happenings. Mike Fallon will be in the studio. He's the Community Relations Coordinator for Webster University. He'll be here with several guests talking about education.
Have all of your legal questions answered by Attorney John Fuller on Legally Yours.
And then Recovery Talk with Carrie Bone. She's a professional outreach representative for the Refuge in Ocklawaha. All of that plus Fun with Joe on the next AM Ocala Live right here on the Source WOCA 96.3 FM.
1370 AM.
All day I faced a barren waste without the taste of water.
Dave Pinglar's favorite song, Cool Waters, because we're around the water cooler on a Tuesday. That means the star of the show is here. Local 6's Dave Pinglar. Hi, David.
Hey, how are you? I got to tell you, you always get me on location. I'm just coming back from vacation. I'm getting ready to get on the plane out of Providence back to Orlando.
Wow. How much time do you have? 5 minutes?
Couple minutes. Yes, I do.
All right, let's get right to it. The word came to us today. Stephen A. Smith will not appear on the show for the next week because of his comments he made about Ray Rice. I know you heard about it. What was your take on that whole thing about Ray Rice and what Stephen A. Smith said?
You know, that was that's what the end. You're talking about what he got for a suspension.
He got actually, yeah, and of course it turns out that Stephen A. Smith got more games than he did. Apparently, he got a week suspension from ESPN. That just broke on the ESPN.
Oh, right, because some of the stuff that he was saying, yeah. And he kind of piled on his comments because then he started tweeting and all that stuff. Right.
And he made the comment that women shouldn't provoke men. Obviously, that was a bad thing to say. And he got a lot of heat from it. Michelle Beadle really took him on to task. And anyway, how did that play out for you down in Orlando?
Well, you know, I followed it. I mean, I've been on travel for the last 11 days, so I've been following it more nationally than than I did when I was working there. But, you know, it's a situation that the NFL, they thought was obviously was the right punishment in their eyes for a couple of games. And, you know, there was a lot of arguments made why they would do that. And from what I followed, I mean, I guess they're probably their stance would be they know this is, again, what I think they're thinking is they have more of, what it actually happened, that they know more of the story than the public knows. Yeah. So that's the only reason I can think of they came up with two games. I thought it would be more, but – it's the NFL. So
yeah, and I thought it'd be more, and I think probably part of the part that happened before the elevator opened up and she was dragged out, we don't know about that. Although we said before, no matter what happened, short of a gun being pulled on him, there's no way he should lay her hands on a woman. He should lay his hands on a woman. The fact that they married later, whatever, that's one thing. But I think the consensus is that the NFL went a little light on this. But as you said, they knew more than we did.
Correct. Yeah, that's the only thing I can come up with two games for.
Yeah.
The other thing I think that Roger Goodell would say, you know.
Sure.
You know, he would probably say he's not a judge. You know, he's not. It's not a court of law, so he can do whatever he wants. He could say it's for 10 games. It's really up to the commissioner, really.
Yeah.
So who knows what plays into it? We don't know what plays into that.
Yes, that's correct. You heard about, maybe you didn't, you've been on vacation, Big Poppy hitting the home run and flipping his bat over and looking, glaring into the dugout, and then David Archer coming back and saying what he said about Big Poppy thinking he's the show. A little bit of a feud going there between the Rays and the Red Sox. What are your thoughts about Big Poppy's gestures like that?
Well, you know, being up here in New England for the last 10 days or so, I saw that highlight, and I was actually watching the game at the time. You know, it's a show. I mean, it's what they do. You know, you covered sports. I mean, there's some guys that are just, you know, it's like a guy getting an interception and doing his rant. You know, it's a show. You know, is it bad sportsmanship? Probably, but those guys, it's a show for them. It's like a circus.
I agree. I think that's that's exactly what it is, and part of it is Big Poppy. He is part of the show. So I know you're on a tight schedule here, but I don't want to keep you longer. But Dave, Tom, all right, one more question. I'll let you get out of here because I don't got things to do. we got football coming up here finally. This was the last Sunday without football for a while. What's the number one storyline for the Great Pinkster in football this year?
Well, I guess there's probably two, and how will Florida State continue their success? And probably the biggest story has got to be, are the Gators going to be awful? That's really going to be the story. I mean, when you start this football season, you know Florida State's going to be good with Jameis Winston and his guy Diaz back with Jimbo, but really the big story will be, will the Florida Gators be awful again? I mean, we'll find out in the next couple of months, but that's got to be the big story.
Here's one to go out on. You know, this is the quarterback state. After all, you know, there have been 9 Heisman Trophy winners here. How many of them are quarterbacks, do you know?
That's a good question.
All 9.
Two?
All 9 are quarterbacks.
Charlie Ward.
3-3. That's
James
correct.
Winston. Oh, yeah.
All Jenny, 3. Yeah. Werfel, Spurrier, and Tebow, and Testaverde. Well, anyway, the 3-3-3. So you might make a case of this being the state in college football for quarterbacks.
Yeah.
All right, David, you have a good flight. And are you coming home or are you going?
I'm on my way home.
Have a safe trip home, Dave. Thanks for joining us, man.
All right, guys,
take care. Dave Pingelor, you won't see him tonight, but he'll be back soon at his desk.
I didn't think about that chart. Winky, Charlie Ward, and
I'll give it to you.
Jameis Winston.
Yeah, I'll give it to you in my go along. That was a little tease.
Wow.
Yeah.
I forgot that it's so evenly spread out, too, 3-3-3.
Yeah, that's a piece I'm working on for Southern Pigskin. It's also my commentary and go along, which is coming up after the break, about is this a breeding ground? And also the fact that at the Brantley camp over the weekend, there's a lot of DNA around there for quarterbacks. And I'll tell you, the genealogy that you start tracking.
Let me ask you this. You were there at the Brantley camp this weekend. I know that Jeff Driscoll, it was said in the paper that Jeff Driscoll said he would come to the camp and could he bring some friends with him, and he brought some. You were looking at him. You saw him throw.
I'm going to tell you during my commentary.
Okay, that's what I want to know.
I watched him throw for quite a while.
You watched him throw. I
watched his receivers, who looked pretty good, by the way.
They can actually catch a football?
Yes. Yeah. I'll tell you what.
We laugh, but that's been a problem at Florida the last three or 4 years.
I mean, what I saw, of course, this is just, you know, this is just in shorts. Who knows? But I'll tell you all about the camp. I'll tell you what I saw. I'll tell you what how you looked. Tell you what I thought of what I saw. And and yours is on let kids be kids, huh?
Yeah, it has to do with Rivals put out a new list of 5-star prospects, and it sort of rankled me. And I'll tell you why.
Can you really get all that excited about whether it's a 5 stars or 4 stars or 3 stars? I mean, can you really get all that excited about it? I mean, after all, it's a designation by somebody.
It is, but this riled me up because of who these kids are.
Okay. All right. And I'll pull out my little trusty football magazines, and I'll give you a few stats out of there in the preseason. By the way, we got to start boning up on things in terms of, you know, who's coaching where. And getting doing our homework because the season's upon us. So come back. We'll talk about that. We'll have our go-longs. We'll tell you a little about the selection committee. We talked about it some before. It's a different kind of game now.
They're going to get – that selection committee is going to become very, very important.
And actually, there's a pretty good breakdown here in Lindy's on if you had playoff matchups back in the day, you know, when you went back and you under the BCS format, when you had 4 games, you had the playoff plus one, how they break down.
TC would have won a whole bunch. Yeah.
Well, I'll tell you what, who would have matched up at least about that, all right? All right, that wraps up this segment. Stay tuned, more on the other side on Buddy Sports Page.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM. We're live and local on the source.
What happiness is to you? Because I'm happy, I'm alone. If you feel like that's what you want to do.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And so is State Farm agent Angie Lewis, working hard to serve her community as a citizen and insurance agent. Angie wants to help you as you adjust your insurance needs to your life, from everything to helping educate your teen driver to protecting your family against everyday risk. She wants to change the way you perceive insurance by developing relationships with her clients, which is why Angie and her staff are proud to be a part of so many good causes in Ocala. In turn, she has chosen to single out those who step up as leaders. Each month on The Voice of Ocala, Angie spotlights a good neighbor, saluting those who give exceptional service or do random acts of kindness to others. For this, Angie was written up in State Farm's National Magazine. Angie also supports local businesses with a regular Biz Buzz. The Angie Lewis State Farm Agency is located at 1122 Northeast 36th Avenue, where visitors are always welcome and the coffee pot is always on.
It's the ultimate summer staycation, just minutes from downtown Ocala, but miles away from the ordinary. A summer sports or summer golf membership at Golden Ocala Golf and Equestrian Club is your all-inclusive ticket to a summer filled with activities and fun from June through September. A summer membership at Golden Ocala opens the door to a world-class setting. Is golf your game? Is tennis your passion? Or is lounging poolside more your speed? Want to get in shape? Work out in the state-of-the-art fitness center and then relax and unwind in the sauna or the spa. Summer members also have use of the equestrian center at Golden Ocala, offering full board and paddock, impeccable trails, and a jumping ring for riders of all ages. Summer memberships are going fast. So visit goldenocala.com and explore the options. Golden Ocala Golf and Equestrian Club. This summer, you can live there and still play here.
Your official news source, WOCA.
Fox News Radio, I'm Karen McHugh. The president hits Russia with more sanctions.
Today, and building on the measures we announced 2 weeks ago, the United States is imposing new sanctions in key sectors of the Russian economy. Energy, arms, and finance.
The U.S. joins with the EU. The sanctions are in response to the shootdown of Malaysia Flight 17. An American in West Africa has died from the Ebola virus.
Two other American aid workers remain in isolation after contracting Ebola in Liberia. One of them, Dr. Grant Brantley, remains in grave condition. The other, Nancy Reitbol, is said to be stable.
Fox's Paul Tilsey on Capitol Hill.
On this vote, the yeas are 97, nays are 0. Confirmation is confirmed.
The Senate confirms former P&G CEO Robert McDonald is the new head of the Department of Veterans Affairs. The 61-year-old McDonald takes over the troubled agency following the resignation of Eric Shinseki. Fox News. We report, you decide.
I'm Lex Friedman. I run my own business, so I know from experience, hiring new employees can be tough. Posting your job in one place isn't enough to find quality candidates. If you want to find the perfect hire, you need to post your job on all the top job sites, and now you can. With ZipRecruiter.com, you can post your job to 50-plus job sites, including Craigslist, LinkedIn, and Twitter, all with a single click. Find candidates in any industry nationwide. Just post once and watch your qualified candidates roll in to ZipRecruiter's easy-to-use interface. No juggling emails or calls to your office. Quickly screen candidates, rate them, and hire the right person fast. Find out today why ZipRecruiter has been used by over 200,000 businesses. And right now, our listeners can post jobs on ZipRecruiter for free by going to ZipRecruiter.com/info. That's ZipRecruiter.com/info. One more time. To try it for free, go to ZipRecruiter.com.
Get it for less at the DIY Home Center Outlet. Get top quality real wood cabinets the same or less than the big box stores are selling the cheap stuff. And that's not all. Drywall screws big box stores are $6.47 a pound. At DIY, only $4.99. Plus, DIY has the largest selection of mobile home parts and accessories anywhere. From carpet to doors, get the DIY supplies you need for less. The DIY Home Center Outlet. We are your building material closeout store. 2191 Northwest 10th Street, just 2 miles east of I-75.
Now is the time to take advantage of Florida Credit Union's CD specials. Our 36-month CD comes in at 1.26% APY. A 24-month is working for you at 1.0% APY. And our 12-month at 0.75% APY. All CD rate specials require $10,000 minimum. With friendly service and rates like these, it's not hard to see why Florida Credit Union has your CD options covered. Florida Credit Union, connecting your money to your life. Call 352-237-8222 for more information. Must act by 1/15/14.
Got a garden, and we've got a show for you called You've Got a Garden with your host, Master Gardener Carol Ann Baldwin. Carol Ann answers your questions about your flowers, your veggies, your grass, your trees, even questions about your bugs. And she's only on WOCA, so don't miss Carol Ann Baldwin and You've Got a Garden each Tuesday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. right here on WOCA The Source.
I'm Yvette, and I'm here to tell you a few things about ABC Frederick's Appliance. They sell not only new, but used guaranteed appliances. When you call ABC Frederick's Appliance, they will provide service on what they sell and any appliances that you own. ABC Frederick's Appliance is located in Bellevue, right over the railroad tracks. Call 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. ABC Frederick's Appliance.
Faced a barren waste without the taste of water, cool water. Old Dan and I with throats burned dry and soul.
All right, so Stephen A. Smith will sit out for a week. They didn't really say they suspended him, but what they said was he won't be doing the show the next week. So,
well, isn't that suspended?
I guess. Unless they just got to decide to take a vacation or something. Unpaid. Stephen A. Smith, you knew there had to be more coming.
Well, you just can't say what Stephen A. Smith said. He said, I ain't saying you should hit a woman, but women provoke getting hit sometimes, and they need to watch what they say so they don't provoke it.
Right off the bat, he wishes those words would have come back in his mouth. But then he did have a chance to get out of it, and he didn't.
He said, what I said was, Nobody should ever touch a woman, but women need to understand that they do things at times that anger men to the point where they'll hit them.
People have said less and gotten fired.
Yes.
So Stephen A. Smith will sit down for a week. Means the air will be easier to breathe from.
And what does that do? Didn't we just have a story that just came out in a book about the chauvinistic attitude of ESPN towards women?
Yeah, that was a book written a little while ago, but we had that.
But we just talked about it, and now here's another example that ESPN maybe don't get the message that women are half as responsible for the function of the world as men are.
I would say a little more.
Well, you know what I mean? Not half. That women are just as
important.
Right, as men, important.
If not
right.
more.
Right, and ESPN's attitude towards women doesn't seem like it's changed very much.
Yeah, that doesn't help their cause any at all, for sure. So, all right, so today, Byron Scott was announced as the Los Angeles Lakers coach.
Tom James, happy about that a bit.
He should be here bragging, bro. What did you say? So all this time he's been waiting, and he's not on the air today. Well,
you want me to give you – I got two. I did not know that. Can I give you one of them right
sure,
now?
Sure, go ahead. No, I got one on mine. I hope it's not the same one.
Is it Byron Scott?
Yeah.
The seventh Laker coach?
No, it's not the one.
Byron Scott is the seventh former Lakers coach to become – the Lakers player to become head coach.
Mm-hmm.
I wouldn't get too excited, Tom James. Pat Riley and Jerry West are the only ones that coach more than 1 year.
Wow. I did not know that. Yeah, there you go.
So don't get too excited.
Yeah, for sure. Let's chat for a second before we go into our wrap on our go-longs. Mine's on the rich heritage of Gator quarterbacks, a thought that came to
Florida America. Quarterbacks.
Well, no, it's actually Gator quarterbacks. Florida is the breeding ground for quarterbacks, the state, but the rich heritage of the Gator quarterbacks is what this is about.
Okay.
This whole thing with LPGA, this is significant for our community. You know, CP's always talking about, well, more events, more jobs. And so now we've got this event coming and my hat's off to the folks out at Golden Ocala Golf and Equestrian Club. The deal announced Monday by Joe Donnelly and Randall Coates, who's the CEO of Coates Golf. It's so good to have things happening like this. I'm really proud of our community. I'm proud of the fact we have the State Junior College Basketball Tournament here now. I wish we had a baseball stadium, but we don't. Hopefully one day we will. And the LPGA is a good way to start, you know, to get things going again. So that's a very positive sign. I just want to say kudos to the folks out of Golden, Ocala, and to Mr. Coates for pulling that off.
Well, and they had the Mid-American Amateur, the Women's Mid-American Amateur out there about 3 years ago, which is a big deal with the USGA. And I'm sure that laid the groundwork for the LPGA to understand it was a good enough golf course to hold these events. But, I mean, this is the major leagues of women's golf.
Yeah.
This is the female equivalent of the PGA. This isn't no...
No, it's not any rummy little thing. This is the real deal.
This is
the major league.
Michelle Wee, the U.S. Open champion, is going to be there. This is a big deal.
Yeah, that'd be great. And by the way, just so addressing, we're talking about women so much today, about how they're getting smarter, faster than men, and we talked about how Stephen A. made a bad mistake, whatever. The whole issue with, you mentioned this, I think, in the story earlier, is that when they talked about the sponsor, Coates Golf, and Randall Coates, of course, is the CEO. But the woman, the person who pushed it through,
his wife
Molly.
Yeah.
According to Ocala.com, said Molly, the president of Coast Golf, spearheaded the effort to land the tournament in Ocala. So
yeah, because the LPGA tried to force them to do it in Orlando, and they said nope.
Yeah. And so this goes to show, if you want something done, give it to a woman to get it done. There you go. That's what happens.
That's why Ashley's running the board.
There you go. Probably be running this show in another week if she stays around.
If she stays around, she probably will be.
All right, before we go to the other thing, finally, congratulations to Ocala Stampede. They beat the Laredo Heat and the defending champion Austin Aztecs in back-to-back nights. And now they're sitting there two games away from the USL Premier Development League National Championship. So congratulations to Shane Roberts his team. That's pretty good stuff right there.
And they owned Austin, a team that beat them last year 3-2 to knock them out of the playoffs. And Laredo knocked them out of the playoffs the year before. So they got revenge over two teams that knocked them out of the playoffs last two. And the Austin game, I listened to the Austin game on the radio, wasn't even close. The Stampede controlled that game.
Stampeded them.
Yeah, they did. They really did. They were pressing the action the entire game. I mean, they just outplayed Austin in every facet of the game.
Southern Conference champion. Now they're going to turn their attention to the Kitsap Pumas.
Yeah.
Kitsap, Washington. And they're the winners of the Western Conference. That'll be played Friday. National semifinal game out in Pontiac, Michigan. So good luck to the Stampede. We had a conversation a moment ago about these coaches, the coaching changes. And I'm just doing my homework now.
That's why I know all these coaches. No problem. I know them all.
Sure you do. Okay, well, let me just give you.
Jeff Munkin went to Army.
I was going to say, you probably don't even know who's coaching now at Georgia Southern.
I know he used to coach at Stephen F. Austin. You just told me his name a minute ago, and I still
can't
remember.
Stuff.
I still don't know it.
All right. Willie Fritz is a new
Willie
coach.
Willie Fritz.
So when you're asked who your team's coach is.
Willie Fritz.
You need to say Willie Fritz. Now, maybe
Jeff
Munkin
left Georgia Southern.
I'll
went
give
to
you
Army.
Some easy ones, okay?
Yep.
Who's the new coach at Penn State?
Franklin. James Franklin.
Yes, that's correct. Who took his place at Vanderbilt?
I have no idea.
Derek Mason.
Okay.
Pretty impressive guy at SEC Media Days, by the way. Okay. You know who got fired at USC? Lane Kiffin.
Lane Kiffin, right, yeah.
Ed Orgeron took over.
Right.
And now he's out. And who is the head coach now of of Tom James' favorite college football team?
No idea.
Yes, you do.
No
he came
idea.
From down from Washington.
No idea.
He was formerly an offensive quarterback.
Sarkisian or whatever?
Yes.
Steve Sarkisian,
yeah. So remember, USC, got a memory, son. I'm helping myself out here, too, because I'm doing a little bit of
I worry about – the SEC teams and then one Sun Belt team, because that's all the football that really matters on the face of the earth in college football.
Well, you might be a few others.
Well, Florida State matters. But other than that, Florida State, all the SEC teams, and Georgia Southern.
You care about the one out in Austin, Texas, don't you?
No.
You get Austin, Texas. You know who's that? You know that coach is.
Charlie Strong.
Thank you. I'm just
Louisville.
We're trying to do a little bit of work.
Took over at Louisville, Bobby Petrino.
Thank you. Now we're sorted. You're getting the drift on this. We're trying to remember, playing the memory game, okay? And so
who's going to be out at Mississippi State after this year? Dan Mullen.
Florida, take his place. Florida Atlantic. Who got fired at Florida Atlantic?
Pelini for
Thank
smoking
you,
dope.
Carl Pelini. And Charlie Partridge took his place. I'll give you one more, and you should get to it. Well, maybe not. You know who left Boise State?
Chris, what's Chris's last name? Chris Peterson, yeah.
Chris Peterson. You know who took his place?
No idea.
What's my son-in-law's last name?
Brendan Martin.
No, son-in-law.
Oh, son-in-law. Gregory.
Thank you. Bob Gregory is the new coach at Boise State. So I'm just trying to help you out a little bit, man. Come on.
And I know the Penn State coach is now in the NFL.
Coach Houston. O'Brien.
Yeah, the Texas – Bill O'Brien.
Yeah.
Down in Texas.
All right, together we'll work this thing out, okay?
It's becoming such a carousel on a yearly basis.
It is.
It's only going to get worse, isn't it?
All right, should we go over the what-ifs? Maybe we'll save this for tomorrow. Okay. About what would have happened if they had the 14 playoffs starting back in 1998, what four teams would have played?
Let's do that tomorrow.
Do it tomorrow because we don't have time. Let's go on with our
time to go long with our
little spiel here. All right, you want me to go first or you want to go?
You go.
All right. Is the state of Florida a breeding ground for great quarterbacks? What other state can count nine Heismans, all quarterbacks? I got to thinking about this after I attended the Brantley quarterback camp over the weekend, where I watched two former Gator signal callers overseeing the present Florida starter do his work. And just by osmosis, Jeff Driscoll had to absorb some of the orange and blue heritage that surrounded him. When you break down the Gator genealogy and the state of Florida could lay claim to the promised land for college players hoping to exceed to a place among the elite to have ever played the position. To wit, you know who had the most quarterbacks to win Heisman? Notre Dame, four, but none since John Hewitt in 1964. However, Miami, Florida State, and Florida each boast three Heisman quarterbacks. Florida has three statues out front of Ben Hill Griffin Stadium to commemorate Steve Spurrier, Danny Werfel, and Tim Tebow. This is not even counting quarterbacks who won multiple SEC titles or national championships like Shane Matthews, Chris Leak, no Heisman, won a national championship. This all happened by the design of fate. Some people like to point out that all three Heisman winners, the statues at Florida, are sons of ministers. And without Ray Gray snatching the prize recruit out of Tennessee in 1963, none of it would have happened. Ray Graves begat Steve Spurrier, who begat Danny Werfel, who was Tim Tebow's idol, so Danny sort of begat Tim. From his vantage point, 100 miles away in high school, Jeff Driscoll dreamed of being next in line. After a season and three games, Driscoll was struck down with a broken leg. Now he is making his way back. Under the blazing July sun at Brantley's camp, the father-son duo of Brantley's watched and approved of Driscoll's work ethic. John Brantley III said, "I was impressed with Jeff. I'm a fan of his." John III was Steve Spurrier's first quarterback and his first coaching job at Florida. Spurrier was the quarterback coach for Doug Dickey in 1978. And then son Johnny was the nation's number one recruited quarterback when he flipped from Texas to University of Florida, but sat 3 years before getting his shot behind Tebow. There were some tough moments, but John has and Johnny have no regrets. They're both still Gator through and through, and they mentored a small class of high school players, some of whom might not even play college ball, and as John Brantley said, some of them might not even start at their high school. "I still use some of the drills I learned from Coach Spurrier," said the Trinity Catholic coach. "This is our way of giving back." So from Spurrier to Driscoll and all those in between, Gator fans owe a debt of gratitude for the quarterbacks who gave them some good times.
Very well said, and the lineage of Florida quarterbacks can't be denied.
We can go over that list of Heisman people if you want to. Let's take a break, come back, and let you do your go along, and we'll do our little wow, I did not know that, coming up next right here on Buddy Sports Pitch.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
Regions Bank has big bank ability but possesses small bank agility. Utilizing tools like Raymond Andrews and his team of six mortgage experts with 100 years of experience in the mortgage industry and 50 years experience as members of the Regions Bank team. Mortgage lending is personal and important, and you deserve someone that will lead you through a positive process. Raymond and his team use local mortgaging processes like local appraisers and local closing to help you have a positive experience, and they habla Espanol as well. So whether you need a conventional, FHA, USDA, or VA loan, or you even need a construction loan, the mortgage team of your local Regions Bank has the knowledge and experience to guide you through the process. So contact Raymond Andrews and his team of mortgage experts at 352-854-4104. That's 352-854-4104. Regions Bank, it's time to expect more.
Right on the southwestern corner of the square sits one of the finest dining establishments in Florida, Mark's Prime Steakhouse and Seafood Restaurant. Mark's offers big city dining amenities in a charming and small town setting. It's a rare treat to experience both the ambiance and the exquisite cuisine in a friendly atmosphere. Ocala's finest restaurant serves the finest beef, the freshest seafood, premium wines, and naturally fresh vegetables. From valet parking to splendid service, Mark's offers the complete package. Check it out today. Mark's Prime Seafood and Steakhouse Restaurant.
If you need a sign or a banner for your yard or your business or your campaign, I'd recommend you go to Signs Unlimited at 318 South Magnolia in Ocala. Screen printing, embroidery, digital graphics. Do what I did when we needed signs for the Save the Marion Theater Group. Go see Vic Buttermore at Signs Unlimited if you want quality work with a fast turnaround from somebody who is deeply committed to his community and always ready to assist you. There's a reason Vic's slogan is, it's our business to make your business better. Sign up for Signs Unlimited. Call 732-7341 today.
Got a garden and we've got a show for you called You've Got a Garden with your host, Master Gardener Carol Ann Baldwin. Carol Ann answers your questions about your flowers, your veggies, your grass, your trees, even questions about your bugs. And she's only on WOCA, so don't miss Carol Ann Baldwin and You've Got a Garden each Tuesday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. right here on WOCA The Source.
Stay informed on everything going on in the villages with the Village Spectator newspaper. The Village Spectator is exclusively devoted to the villages with news, commentary, and more. And yes, they have Tom's Picks, a free referral for people who are looking for a company to do work for them. Tom's Picks will refer the company that fits your needs, and all we ask is that you tell them where you heard about them. Call Tom's Picks at 804-1223 and pick up your copy of the Village Spectator today.
Now read Ocala Downtown Newspaper online.
News Talk 1370. WOCA invites you to discover your full business potential. News Talk Radio is the perfect environment for your advertising. WOCA's News Talk format pinpoints information hungry, better educated, high income adults. So use us to talk to them. Call 732-8000. 732-8000. We're Ocala News Talk Radio. News Talk 1370. WOCA.
Hey, I'm Gary.
And I'm Eric. Did you know that Red Eye Radio is on WOCA The Source every night from 2 to 6 a.m. and it's live?
That's right. No tape shows here.
We know that the news doesn't sleep.
And neither do we. So we're here with you live from 2 till 6 a.m. every weekday. Call us 866-90-RED-EYE. So join me, Gary McNamara.
And me, Eric Harley, every weeknight to discuss the latest in news and entertainment.
Right here on WOCA The Source.
WOCA, News Talk 1370. Good talk, great conversation.
All day I faced a barren waste without.
We're back on the Voice of Ocala Buddy Sports page. During the break, we were talking about coming up with a list of quarterbacks in Florida, Buddy, and we may have overstated one.
Well, my bad. Actually, I counted Bernie Kosar, who did not win a Heisman. So there's eight on two at Miami. So it's 3-3-2. So, yeah, we got to thinking about that. We couldn't think of the third one. And we thought, hey, wait a minute. We're missing one. Who is it? And obviously, I counted three, and it's only two. So I apologize to the Florida State Seminoles and the Florida Gators because they have three apiece, and Miami has two quarterbacks.
All right, now I'm going to go long. Rivals.com released its top five-star recruits for the 2016 season. Yes, you heard that correctly, the 2016 season. These 16 supposed elite athletes are just entering their junior year of high school. Yeah, you heard that right, too, their junior year of high school. Over the next 2 years, you will hear of press conferences from the likes of Nate Craig, Jacob Eason, Ben Cleveland, and Dexter Lawrence, just to name a few of Rivals' new 16 top five-star can't-miss recruits. Really? Five stars? Some of these kids aren't even 15 yet. In the world of Got to Report It First, kids are placed on pedestals that... Some put much pressure on them that they have no chance to succeed. Undoubtedly, the letter from hundreds of programs will begin to flow into their mailboxes of these kids' home. Coaches, handlers, or vultures, as I call them, you decide which term you agree with, will start giving these children advice as dollar signs begin to dance in the heads of these adult scumbags. The entourage will take form, the press conference scheduled, and the spectacle that will become the college selection will take place. I remember when I was a football player in high school, we had a running back named Kevin Flowers who was pursued by the likes of Georgia, Clemson, Georgia Tech, Auburn, and the almighty Alabama. You know who helped him decide on Clemson as his final choice? His granddad. They talked about the closeness of home, best education opportunities, and the major he wanted, and the Kevin liked tigers as an animal. All this was decided on a lazy Sunday afternoon, and you know what Kevin did once he decided? He called some of his buddies, and I was grateful I was to be one of them, and we went out and played putt-putt, because that's what kids do. Maybe Rivals and all the other outlets should try and remember, these aren't adults who can handle adult stress. These are kids. Let them be kids.
All right, very good, sir. That is kind of the time when you should enjoy your situation there, and you should have it fun. It's got to be high pressure. It's very tough for the kids. Okay, time for I did not know that. Kind of a soft landing by Byron Scott as coach of the Lakers, but the Showtime gang turned up in L.A. today to show support and create some buzz. Byron Scott is 53 years old, just 17 years older than Kobe Bryant.
Wow, I did not know that.
So Kareem and those guys showed up there to welcome their former teammate.
Finally, mine one. Derek Jeter just passed Corey Skimpsy, seventh on the all-time hits list. Only one pitcher allowed a home run to both of them, Dennis Martinez.
Wow, I did not know that. I think our guest Dave Pingler was in today. And, of course, great job by Ashley on the board today. My broadcast partner, the Tribunator, Tom Schmitz. I'm Buddy Martin. Have a great night, everybody.
Hello, I'm Dawn Lovell, lead event designer and owner at Party Time Rentals. Have you ever wondered what it takes to make an event spectacular? Well, look no further. It's what we do every day. Whether you're hosting an intimate dinner for 10 or a gala for thousands, at Party Time Rentals, we find just the right style and elegance to make your event a success. Our extensive inventory of the finest in chandeliers, tents, crystal, china, and specialty items...